Thursday, the third day already of November 2016. We're only 4 days out from the most important election in modern times, perhaps ever. It's such an incredible time to be alive. We now even have Brett Baer at Fox News saying their FBI sources say that Hillary and others could be indicted very soon. That's what my sources told me last Friday. We broke that first. Here's John Bowne reporting.
America is showing Hillary Clinton and her accomplices the door. The FBI is underway on not one, but five criminal investigations into the iniquitous tentacles of Hillary Clinton. They include the reopened email case, an ongoing investigation into the Clinton Foundation, the investigation of Anthony Weiner's sexting of a 15-year-old girl, which involved Hillary aide Huma Abedin, an investigation into the Podesta Group and its ties to alleged corruption involving the former Ukrainian president, and the investigation of the Clintons' ties into the illegality of Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe's foreign donation contributions from Chinese billionaire Wang Wenling. The Democrats are reaching claustrophobic levels of panic, blaming everyone under the sun but themselves.
We do know that our democracy is under assault by the KGB. I mean, to me, that's something we ought to be talking about. That's a very public revolution in this campaign. And people have to decide, do we want our country for ourselves or the people in charge, or are we going to let the KGB and the House Republicans decide this election?
Sorry, Mr. Carville. Failing left-leaning outpost, the New York Times reported, law enforcement officials say that none of the investigations so far have found any conclusive or direct link between Mr. Trump and the Russian government. And even hacking into Democratic emails, FBI and intelligence officials now believe was aimed at disrupting the presidential election rather than electing Mr. Trump. But Hillary keeps on swinging for the fences as she attacks her accusers.
I'm sure a lot of you may be asking what this new email story is about and why in the world the FBI would decide to jump into an election with no evidence of any wrongdoing.
No evidence, lady, it's a joke. We already have all the emails.
No evidence of any wrongdoing.
There is no case here.
But even the former DNC committee chairman Ed Rendell cautions Hillary against attacking the FBI. Even the White House doesn't want to condemn the FBI. They are hedging their bets.
You know, every time Donald thinks things are not going in his direction, he claims whatever it is rigged against him. There was even a time when he didn't get an Emmy for his TV program.
You have all the emails, lady. You rigged the polls, everything.
Were rigged.
You should have gotten it.
This is a mindset. This is how Donald thinks. And it's funny, but it's also really troubling.
Meanwhile, Hillary can't even accept the election process. Reuters reports Democratic Party officials sued Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump in four battleground states on Monday, seeking to shut down a poll-watching effort they said was designed to harass minority voters in the November 8th election. In lawsuits filed in federal courts in Pennsylvania, Nevada, Arizona, and Ohio, Democrats argued that Trump and Republican Party officials were mounting a campaign of vigilant voter intimidation that violated the 1965 Voting Rights Act and an 1871 law aimed at the Ku Klux Klan. Senator Ron Johnson is already preparing Congress for the impeachment hearings should Hillary win. Meanwhile, Trump's numbers keep increasing. Investor Business Daily shows Trump and Clinton tied after Hillary's lead disappeared. The stock market, a bellwether that has called 19 out of 22 elections, has been sliding in the recent weeks, spelling out the country's dissatisfaction of the incumbent Democratic Party's economic nightmare and heralding a win for Donald Trump. Hillary will one way or another have to face the will of the American people, as deplorable as she perceives it to be. John Bowne for Infowars.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got all the numbers coming in. Mainstream television, mainstream print media is in freefall collapse. Their third quarter revenue is down 97%. Meanwhile, the new independent media, patriotic pro-truth, is exploding. It's all coming up straight ahead with total election coverage. November 8th is a very important date. Vote like the world depends on it. Thank you so much for joining us. We're going to be live here for the next 4 hours, and we have the InfoWars Nightly News coming up tonight, 7 o'clock Central. Normally, that is just for subscribers and TV stations that pick it up, but starting tonight, right through the election, we're going to have that Nightly News feed, obviously, every night posted to the front page of InfoWars.com, as well as emailed out to folks that are part of the free newsletter at InfoWars.com/newsletter. And, of course, we will have a 52-hour live broadcast that kicks off at 11 a.m. Monday, runs right through 24 hours the next day, solid, and then into the next day at 3 o'clock. Then we take a break for a few hours, and the Nightly News comes back with any new developments Wednesday night. Undoubtedly, all the stops have been pulled out when it comes to fake polls, when it comes to media bias, when it comes to Google admittedly gaming the internet and search results for Hillary. Every trick, every dirty trick, every lowdown trick, every underhanded trick, every naked trick, every brazen trick, you name it, they've thrown the kitchen sink at populism with the Brexit and failed, and now they've thrown more than the kitchen sink. They've thrown the bathtub, the plumbing, the drywall, everything at the Donald Trump movement. Trump had the courage to buck the mainstream media. Trump had the instincts to stand up for nationalism. He's not perfect. None of us are, but he's our champion now. And we are 4 days out right now. They're canceling school across the country in many areas. They're admittedly preparing for civil unrest at levels never before seen. The Soros groups have been fully activated. They have increased funding many, many times what it previously was for disruptions. This is the greatest threat this nation has ever faced. That's why there has been counter coups in what's left of the good intelligence community out there in our government, which is substantive, against the globalist coup through Hillary Clinton. And they're just busy rubbing our faces in it. They see how weak the population is in places in trendy areas. They see how weak people are in the Mark Dice videos. They see how dumbed down people are in the statistics. And they just think everyone's like that. And they have total, abject, complete contempt. More and more they're realizing you may have the majority of people in a mind-numbed, psychological fetal position under mass Stockholm syndrome via learned helplessness and normalcy bias. But you have not moved the Overton window for many of us from our republic to hell that you're trying to basically set up. So coming up today, 4 days out, William Jasper, editor of the New American Magazine, the folks who were first fighting the New World Order starting in 1956. Boy, they've been proven correct in triplicate. He'll be joining us to talk about his views on the world. And then we've got Colonel Tony Schaefer, who, of course, blew the whistle on the government not killing bin Laden in 2000, 2001, ordering stand downs, and, of course, then exposing Benghazi and then exposing Syria. He's been one of our main sources on air and obviously off air. He hasn't given us anything classified, but he's directed us towards things that are already publicly available. And along with his analysis and a lot of other people, we were able to first break what happened with Benghazi and what's currently happening with Obama and Hillary backing Al-Qaeda and other Wahhabist groups known as ISIS out of Saudi Arabia. And that's what Dr. Steve Pachinik, former head of psychological warfare for the State Department, the U.S. Army, the Pentagon, Central Intelligence Agency, I mean, he's run operations for all those groups. And he's obviously getting ready to talk about even more on air. He is risking his life big time because he has been where the bodies are buried. You can believe it. Overthrowing at least 8 countries. So he'll join us for a full hour tomorrow. We had a great interview yesterday, but I was letting him talk about 80% of the time. But I saw some complaints that I was still saying, hey, get into the counter coup. Get into the shadow government. Get into what's coming out of this. Get into what dirty tricks you might play. I know he was specifically, though, not communicating with the main audience yesterday. He was communicating with people in the intelligence networks and with Uma Abedin and others, letting them know we're coming after you, Wiener and Podesta and others, so you better roll over, which is exactly what the FBI and NYPD are telling him to do right now. So he'll be joining us for an hour tomorrow. I think I'm going to come. In fact, I know I'm going to come in and do a 2-hour broadcast. I mean, I want to rest the crew, but I'm going to come in with a skeleton crew on Saturday and do a couple-hour live roundtable with some folks because I don't want to miss one day as things develop And as things unfold, we normally have the Sunday show, of course, 4 to 6 p.m. I'll be here live for that. We may even expand that coverage. And then we go right into Monday with the 52-hour broadcast that kicks off at 11 a.m. right through Super Tuesday, right through November 8th into the 9th. So please, this is about a revolution of awakening. It's already happened. Spread the word about InfoWars.com. Spread the word about other groups that are fighting for the Republic, Breitbart.com, DrudgeReport.com, WorldNetDaily.com, WND.com, A Daily Caller. And my site's not perfect. Drudge isn't perfect. None of us are perfect, but we're not out to get the country. We want prosperity. We want justice. We want to be secure, and that means having our freedoms. And we want the promise of America back. We're fighting for it. And you know that. And so when you spread the videos we're putting out and you spread the articles, which, by the way, we went from like 200 and something on the web to 200 to 198. I'm told the new algorithm really shows because the way we have our site set up, they're only tracking part of our traffic. But the point is, we're bigger than CNN.com, they now admit. And it's really freaking the establishment out. And InfoWars is only 1/20th or so of all of our reach. When we've got the numbers, it varies like 15 to 25% week to week. We've got all the other platforms, all the other systems. And you put that together, InfoWars dwarfs much of the mainstream media combined. And that's not bragging. It's so you understand how pathetic the enemy is, because I'm not that good. It's that they're that bad. And we're all working together to expose this. If you go to DrudgeReport.com right now, Drudge has a link to the radio shows and TV shows that are covering this live and that are giving you different important, thought-out, not scripted angles. And he's got us there as a second link so folks can find the broadcast and spread it. That's what this is all about. Safety in numbers. Growing the movement. So many people over the years said, Alex is actually trying to change the government. You'll never do it. Or Alex wants to be the system. No, I don't. I want to return the republic. I want to overthrow the counterfeit globalist system. But yes, if it's selling out to win, then I'm a sellout. No, that's not selling out. Selling out, selling out of the current system. I want to change the culture. I'm promoting freedom. I'm promoting choice. I'm promoting justice. I'm promoting classical liberalism that means real free association and live your life how you want as long as you don't hurt somebody else. That's just classic Americana, classic common sense, classic Renaissance, classic enlightenment. I mean, I'm not inventing something new here. I know what we're promoting is a universe better than what the globalists are pushing because they don't want a big open free society with choice. They want monopolies. And so more and more you see what the future is. It's people that get it. And it's people that understand we're coming together through our independence and then creating something even stronger that can't be stopped. It's a very, very, very exciting time to be alive. And it's the opposite of the globalist collectivism that's centralized. This is the collectivism of there's a restaurant in town that has the very best food. It's going to always have its parking lot jam-packed. It's not collective. It's independent. Independent ideas, though, make it number one. And that's what's happening, is that freedom is being rediscovered, and it's unbelievably exciting. Now, let me get into the big news. When the big FBI announcement came out last Friday, I went out and made some phone calls, and they said, oh, yeah, it's much worse than, you know, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's going to be huge. There's going to be a bunch of indictments. There's no way Hillary's going to get out of this. And I said, well, what are the specifics? Well, we can't tell you the specifics. So I did my report, was saying, oh, my gosh, Hillary's going to get indicted sometime after the election. That's what I've been told, because they don't want to make it political. But she better know to stand down what they found and the 650,000 emails, the rest of it. But what was there was the ongoing investigation that's been happening for a year with the NYPD and others. And you heard about this yesterday from some of our sources we had on air, Doug Hagman. Well, it's in the news today. It's up on InfoWars.com. It's Fox News reporting that multiple FBI sources say indictments are coming and that Hillary is basically in deep trouble. Meanwhile, that ties in again to my last Friday's announcement, or Thursday's announcement, and that ties into this report, Insider, FBI uncovered Clinton criminal enterprise on Wiener's PC, looks like sex blackmail NYPD blows whistle on new Hillary Clinton email, money laundering, sex crimes with children, child exploitation, pay to play. Seems like every day I see another one of these from the New York Times or the LA Times, you name it, where they'll have a journalist, sometimes senior journalist, people pretending to be journalists, send out a tweet saying, we need to kill Donald Trump, or somebody needs to kill Donald Trump. They do this over and over again. They've done it again. The story's up on Infowars.com. LA Times journalist hopes for Trump's death. Sickening tweet underscores bias media. He says, I would rather see Donald Trump's life end. Stephen Borowick, I think how you pronounce it. And it's got some weird selfie of him looking all angelic. These people are all on such little delusional power trips as their diminishing empire seeks beneath the waves of zero credibility. And that was because Time had put out an article saying, see Donald Trump's life in photos. This tweet is from Time, is what the LA Times journalist, Stephen at Borowick, was responding to when he said he wanted to see Trump dead. And again, these are all really soft wimps. But they love Hillary overthrowing countries. They love radical Islamists cutting women's genitals off and murdering Christians by the hundreds of thousands. They get off on totalitarianism as long as it's called leftist. They don't care what Hillary does or how many crimes she commits or, you know, how many Lolita Express flights Clinton's on with known pedophiles. They don't care because it's all about delusion. They're the moral high ground people. They're fighting the racist Donald Trump. It doesn't matter Bill Clinton played golf and wouldn't stop and didn't apologize for playing at a golf course where no blacks were allowed. Can't believe they even still have those. It doesn't matter how many times they've come out and, you know, passed minimum sentencing to, quote, keep the black predators at heel. Doesn't matter if they hang out with Grand Dragons. Doesn't matter if the Dixie Mafia put them in power. Doesn't matter if all these chefs and other people say that they're horrible racists. It's okay because Bill Clinton and Hillary are their racist, and they're all part of a club who have jobs at the LA Times and places like that because they go along with the mindless, empty party line. And hey, that's your business. If you're successfully able to steal this election and install Hillary, to the world's horror and to real liberals like Julian Assange's horror, you will only further accelerate your diminished stature to one that can't be found under a microscope. I mean, you truly are jokes. You are making yourselves obsolete, and you associate the centralized power of a hijacked COG system, continuity of government. You take that whole shadow government bureaucracy that's totally illegitimate, and you think because it's made itself above the law that you, by extension, are above the law, but you're not above the law of public opinion, which is the total system in which you survive. It's your atmosphere. Government corruption can hold on a season longer. You can't. You don't have the power of the purse. But more and more, they want to make you buy your media, like the BBC taxes everybody in the UK that has a television set. Or you want to make us buy big banks, overpriced insurance. So that's where this economy's going. It's where they're going to make us buy their products. But that's not going to work either. History's shown it, and no amount of technocracy is going to ever repair any of this for you. You are true jokes. Now, coming up in the next segment that's longer, I've got Donald Trump, who is now ahead 6 points, not 4 points, but six and growing in mainline polls that oversample. We're going to come back with some of a live speech that Trump is engaged in right now that we have posted on Infowars.com. We're also going to get into the clips where FBI sources tell Fox News Clinton Foundation investigation much bigger and indictments likely. That's what I was told last week. But what the NYPD found in the Wiener investigation is unbelievable. It's worse than I thought, and so incredibly reckless, dealing with not just paper play, but trafficking in sex, trafficking reportedly in children. And I was told by high-level sources about 2 weeks ago, let Hillary and the media ignore WikiLeaks. we're trying, I said this 2 weeks ago, we're trying to not hurt the country irrevocably, but it's like emergency cancer surgery. We may have to just go all the way and release the really bad stuff on Hillary and the Democrats. So they want to engage in thermal nuclear option of setting up a coup in this country. Well, the really bad stuff's going to come out. And I'm told there's FBI agents, you name it, ready to have big press conferences. There's data packets ready to go out to everybody. I mean, they'll have to shut the web off and start a war to get out of this. Right now, she could just sail off, not steal the election, let Trump win it. He's way ahead. But they've got the media and the feds and the UN in place with the European Union to steal the election. And they're intending to in 4 days. So that's the big chicken match. We're all in. Boy, I'd be hitting the knee right now. I know I'm doing it. Praying to God. Donald Trump is in Jacksonville, Florida right now, speaking about Obamacare and what a horrible scam it is. And I agree with Trump. I mean, personally, that's one of the things that makes me the maddest about Obama and Hillary is that it's in the WikiLeaks. They plan to bankrupt the economy and implode 1/7 of the economy, that being healthcare, and then come in with an even worse system after it, administered by private interest, ripping us off. I mean, this is our economy being taken over by criminals that tell the lottery mentality public, that is 40% or so, maybe more, that, hey, you're going to get something free. And they just keep hearing it, and they keep wanting to hear it, even though the engine of free market that made us the wealthiest country in the world has, for all intents and purposes, already been blown up. That's what Trump keeps saying. It's your last chance. They're dismantling the country and its borders now. We're going into globalism. They want you poor. That's because that's the real plan. Trump, again, just doesn't have to be out to get us and have fair trade deals and control our borders and have decent health care. Could pay for all the poor people and then just leave the rest alone. It'd be half the cost they estimate. But they won't do it because they want full control. It's unlimited what they can do. And now they're coming after the guns. But the people know. That's why gun sales broke the all-time previous record again last month. The numbers are out today. Biggest spike yet. That's on InfoWars.com. October gun sales see massive spike. See yet another record broken. People know. But let's go to Donald Trump in Jacksonville, Florida.
Of information is coming in. The FBI agents say their investigation is likely to yield an indictment.
That's right. He's live now, but he backed it up. Yeah, back that up again. Did you hear that? Likely to bring an indictment. The perfect place. I said back it up a few minutes. They backed it up like 12 minutes. And there he is saying likely to bring an indictment. Yeah, that's Fox News, Associated Press. They're saying it is just so damning. There's no way to cover it up.
He is investigating how Hillary Clinton put the office of Secretary of State
up for sale.
Up for sale in violation of federal law. The investigation is described as a high priority. It's far-reaching and has been going on for more than 1 year.
Let me tell you what happened.
It was reported that an avalanche of information is coming in.
The intelligence community said we're releasing all the pedophile stuff. If you don't do it, FBI.
Is likely to yield an indictment.
It's called checkmate, Hillary, and all the scum that supported you, and all the filth that backed you. You're as shameful as the Nazis. You are scum. I don't want to hate you, but you deserve hate. You deserve to be despised. You're disgusting. You know, Donald Trump said he liked beautiful women. How evil.
But just remember, the system is rigged. Just remember that. And reports also show the political leadership at the Department of Justice is trying to protect Hillary Clinton and is interfering with the FBI's criminal investigation.
Yeah, they've been appointing Clinton friends and confidants over each investigation. That's in the news. Unprecedented.
By comparison, four-star general just last week, James Cartwright, highly respected, is in very serious trouble. for doing a tiny fraction of what Clinton did.
They're going after him.
To jail for up to 5 years. Think of it. General Cartwright, last week, four-star general, respected by everybody, a tiny, tiny fraction may go to jail for now 5 years. And General Petraeus's life and reputation has been destroyed.
It's all part of the purge.
Nothing by comparison to what Hillary Clinton did. She shouldn't even be allowed to run for the office of president.
That's right. As I said, she's disqualified because of that, and that she stole the nomination.
She stole that. That is where the system is rigged. She shouldn't be allowed. It was also reported that the laptops of Clinton's top aides, which had been slated for destruction, were not, in fact, destroyed. Good job by the FBI.
Yeah, they ordered the FBI to destroy it.
And that the FBI has been successfully using them to gather information for their criminal investigation. Further, they have found new emails as part of the 650,000 emails just recently found. Can you imagine 650,000? What do these people do? No wonder nothing gets done in government.
That's what I said a few days ago. I mean, how are they controlling so much stuff?
I guess you'll say those 650. Remember the 33? Well, the 650,000 also, the wedding and some yoga, right?
That's what she said,
finally,
the wedding and some yoga.
That no less than five foreign intelligence agencies successfully hacked into Clinton's illegal and secure server, which contained classified information, creating an ongoing security threat to the United States.
And by the way, they're now saying, when I said years ago, they were selling it all. That's why there's 650,000. Hillary was part of it. It was a bizarre.
So little by comparison. Think of it.
They were selling it all.
Hillary Clinton has engaged in a massive, far-reaching criminal conduct and equally far-reaching cover-up. She created an illegal email server to shield and guard her activity. It's so simple. So simple. Should have happened a long time ago, folks. Now we're going through phase two, which sounds like it's even worse than phase one. Should have happened in phase one. But she was protected by the Department of Justice.
And we have all the WikiLeaks that are even more open and shut. That's the key, Donald.
She illegally transmitted confidential information and then lied about it to Congress. She illegally destroyed federal records, including 33,000 emails, after receiving a congressional subpoena. And she made 13 phones disappear, some with a hammer. Who in this room has gotten rid of a phone and then smashed the hell out of it with a hammer? Anybody? Raise your hand, please. Raise your hand. I see one hand over there. I see a hand there. What business are you in? I want to know. No, I don't want to know. I don't want to meet him. She engaged in corrupt pay-for-play at the State Department for personal enrichment. She lied to the FBI, and she lied to the American people many, many times. Remember, she lied 39 times. I don't recall.
Well, all right, we're going to come back to more of this in a few minutes. That's Donald Trump in Jacksonville, Florida. Very, very powerful information. You can feel it. You can intellectually see it. You can mathematically calculate it. Hillary's done. And I'm not somebody that says things like that so it becomes reality. Everybody knows I'm a pessimist. She's done. Unless her and Obama try to start a nuclear war or something as a distraction, which has been done before. I mean, not nuclear war, but leaders have started big wars when they're on the verge of being removed or basically overthrown. And if anybody is overloaded with chutzpah and hubris, it's Hillary Clinton. I mean, I was watching the news last night, Obama running around saying a vote for Trump is a vote to persecute women. This guy funded Al-Qaeda and ISIS, murdering women, enslaving women, selling them into sex slavery. All the rappers they have in the White House that openly sing about date rape and pushing some of the most degenerate garbage ever. It's just the total hypocrisy when they're thousands of times worse than Donald Trump. It staggers the mind that their constituents buy into this delusion. It really is mind-boggling. We shot a special report on it that you should send out to everybody. Shocking. Michelle Obama and Hillary caught glamorizing date rape promoters. But it gets worse. There's these weirdo Lena Dunham and all these unfunny comedians that Hollywood pushes that with straight faces get up on TV and go, they have ABC News specials about why she loves Hillary. And then it turns into an 8-minute piece on why white males are the problem. And as soon as we get rid of them, everything will be great. And then the white males all come and sit with their families and hear how bad they are from her, as if white males are some unified group causing trouble. Imagine you said that about Jews or black people or Hispanics. It would be the most racist thing ever. But it's the establishment trying to organize women and minorities into their own race-based cult so that you can't work with people, so that you're incompatible, and so you don't become upwardly mobile in society. The truth is, you go to Indonesia 50 years ago, and you're not Indonesian, you're not getting a job or moving up in that culture. You go to some place in Germany or Japan, same deal. That was just what cultures did. Somehow the white males are the only people that ever had a culture or a country. And then it's Christians that create the true original multiculturalism of an open society and actually end the more primitive associations of humans. And then that gets hijacked by people that are using it to destroy any culture and bring in a plastic corporate culture where we're all each other's throats. Classic racism, classic sexism, classic stereotype with just these reeling, upset, crazy white women mainly just freaking out that they hate men. They've run them off. They're totally alone. They've got their girlfriend. That's not making them happy. They're totally freaked out. They're just screaming, white men, white men. You know, when you drive down the road and see a white guy driving an exterminator truck or see a white guy working on the side of the road or see a white, you know, guy mowing somebody's yard, you drive by, there's a Hispanic guy doing it, a black guy. It's just working class people who are hardworking and go home and go to their kid's baseball game. And their wife takes care of him when he's sick. He takes care of her. They try to go on vacation. They try to live their life. They try to go to a football game. And then they're just sitting there hearing how they did something. It's like, what the hell are you talking about? I'm a white male, folks. I don't know where all these special little privileges and things are. I mean, I'm sure there's something there, but the whole point is, this is all just wealth. If it's so bad, why does everybody want to get here? Because this is where the Christians, and we did a lot of bad stuff in this country, but it was all a free-for-all. The Indians were all killing each other. I use that word, so I'm being politically correct, saying Native Americans. They were all killing each other. They'd kill you if you wouldn't help, you know, go out the other tribe they didn't like. That's no judgment on them. That's how humans operate. They just know the public doesn't have any real history. And so the world's always been about conquest and domination, and it's Christianity that's tried to stop that and make it about free association and free will. And it's real Christianity, not the little fake church that, you know, that just wants your money and to make you feel guilty. That's the opposite of Western civilization. But the real church is what created the prosperity, the freedom, women's revolution. It's what said, we need to build everybody up. We need to build the third world up. Then they turned back against that in the last 100 years and said, oh, white man's burden. You know, Rudyard Kipling, how dare you try to build up the third world? Don't do that. Well, that was the British government changing its view and saying, no, we're going to keep folks in squalor. We're not going to build these people up. That decision was made by the late 40s. That's in the Royal Commission on Population. But see, I'm not a pseudo-intellectual. I actually read the history books from different perspectives. I actually do the research. I know the game plan. Now, I've got a few clips I want to play that are so illuminating because we've got Weld, who from the beginning is a basically Democratic Party operative. We've had the Democratic Party take over the libertarians. The libertarians the party itself, for recognition, totally sold out their name forever. I don't want to be known as libertarian now. They have really, really, really done a number on themselves. He's out endorsing Hillary on the campaign trail. And then Gary Johnson is this arrogant. He acts like a crazy, power-tripping six-year-old. He was in my offices a year ago, and I mean, I told people, I said, something's wrong with that guy. And now you see him degenerating in public, just a complete lunatic in my view. So, I mean, I'm telling you, I thought rubber room time or something. So I don't know what's going on, but man, this is so obvious as a little pissant third-party run to derail Trump, who's taking over the Republican Party. That's what's happening here. 4 days left. You think there's going to be another big October surprise? I do. I think they're going to dig up some more crap. I think they throw everything they can at Trump. But it is quite a time to be alive right now. We're going to come back and go to more of Trump's speech and kind of dole that out through the rest of the broadcast today. But before I go any further, in these times, it's important to have high-quality, storable food. And we've gone out and found the biggest, best, high-quality company. We've been working with them 8 years. One of the largest in the nation because they've scaled up. They have high quality at very low prices. My Patriot Supply. We sell their entire catalog at InfoWarsStore.com. And we have it private labeled under the label InfoWars Select, their full catalog, normally 10% below whatever their biggest special is at the time. We're always changing it as new specials come in. We're under a contract with them. Because, again, they have other distributors. We're the biggest because of this, the private labeling. 30 to 40% off. We're running a special. We only do every few months. Used to be just every once a year, but things are moving so fast. Things are unfolding so fast. We're doing the special more often. Take advantage of it. The purchase also helps fund the operation. InfoWarsStore.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Hundreds of different packages, different meals, special diets, whatever you want, it's there. And we have a new product. I haven't really rolled out yet, but it's here, so we're selling it. It's the ultimate. I mean, for the price. I mean, I'm sure they got stuff you can get from a, you know, cosmetics, top, I mean, even medical doctors that deal with skin, you can probably get something better that costs thousands of dollars. I mean, some of the stuff's incredibly expensive. This is $29.95 with the organic, concentrated, known compounds for healthy skin, hair, nails. I'm really proud of it. It took a lot of time. Actually, had a bottle of it in here earlier. I guess somebody took it out. No, here it is. It's a BioPCA hair and nail formula, and I'm going to cut a piece soon, an ad breaking down the different compounds that are in it and what they've been connected to and what they do. But it contains 10,000 mcg of biotin per serving with collagen, proteins, folate, and more. Just two vegetable capsules daily, 60 in the bottle. Very, 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 very proud of it because, again, the leading competitors out there are $60 to $100. And the thought is if you charge six, seven times markup, that then somehow people think it's worth it and pay it. No, this is top of the line that you would get from a dermatologist. This is top of the line for $29.95. We can sell it for $100 easily. And folks, it's got a 80% markup on it. That's how we fund the operation. But I'm not putting a 200%, 300%, 400% markup on it. No, this is super high quality. Just like Knockout is $19.95, and there's no other sleep aid out there over-the-counter like it. InfoWarsLife.com. Stay with us. We'll be right back. So we have this governor openly endorsing Hillary Clinton. And I said 6 months ago, the guy's a Democrat. He goes out and badmouths Trump everywhere. Gary Johnson clearly is a surrogate for Hillary. He's a total buffoon. He's a total travesty. He's a total joke. And you've got folks sitting it out going, I'm not going to be part of either party. But, you know, I'm just going to take the high road and be for third parties. I'd be all for third parties if we were trying to build an alternate idea. Trump is the Americanism against globalism taking over the Republican Party. And I know that's known, but the Democratic Party has taken over the Libertarian Party, a party that had a lot of good people in it, a lot of good ideas, and it's sickeningly disgusting. And we should hear the party coming out and criticizing Weld and criticizing Johnson. We're not. It's despicable. And that's why he's gone to 2 to 3 points in major polls from upwards of 9 points. He is a joke. A total joke. And they're hoping he takes enough points from Trump to put Hillary into office. We've got major evidence, too, of election manipulation. We're going to be getting to her in a moment. But first, here's Governor Weld, another fake stuff shirt, pseudo-intellectual with a fake intellectual accent. I mean, these people are a plague on this nation.
I can't imagine that you wouldn't tell a person in North Carolina or Ohio to vote for Hillary Clinton if the choice they were making was between giving the Libertarian Party 5% or potentially electing Donald Trump. Because you guys don't have a chance against Donald Trump, and she does. And if they vote for you, you're helping. They would be helping to elect Donald Trump. The Libertarian Party hasn't treated you great if they're putting out statements that you disagree with over your own name. Even now, this one week before the election,
oh,
I can't imagine
baby.
That your loyalty to them is stronger than your fear
Governor
of Trump's
Weld.
President.
Well, I'm here vouching for Mrs. Clinton, and I think it's high time somebody did. And I'm doing it based on my personal experience with her, and I think she's... deserves to have people vouch for her other than members of the Democratic National Committee. Mm-hmm. So I'm here to do that.
So it's all pre-scripted. Rachel Maddow with almost no audience, couple hundred thousand viewers, total joke. Knows she's a joke. Propped up there. Knows Hillary's a monster. Even spoken out against her when she was, quote, pro Bernie Sanders. Total intellectual frauds at the end of their days politically sitting there. Oh, your party's treated you terrible. No. It's let you come in, it's let you piss all over it, it's let you do whatever you want, and then they invert reality again, because here's the guy that's come in, lied about who he is, taken over, tried to get Hillary in, committed basically fraud politically, taking the donations of libertarians that believed in him, he's a hijacker, and then she turns it around, oh, the libertarians aren't treating you good, you poor baby. What are you going to do? What are you going to say for that? Well, I'm here to vouch for Hillary because she deserves it. And then it gets worse. There's another clip. Weld suggests America ignores Clinton's emails. Yeah, Weld, how you going to feel when all the Wiener stuff and the paper play and the Epstein plane comes out? And then Hillary was using it to blackmail people. How you going to feel then if that comes out, Weld? There's no end to these people. They're such jokes when you're around them. They're like walking into walls and just stumbling around. They're just dumb. They're just nobody sellouts that the system goes and uses to throw in front of the American people. They are dishonor. They are fraud. They are deceit. They are anti-Americanism. They are the enemy. They are anathema. They are cancer. They are everything you don't want to be. Everything, if you're a young person growing up, you don't want to be. These people are. Abominations to freedom. Now, when we come back, we're going to talk about some of the scams they're undoubtedly already preparing, like projections. We're going to look for early network projections starting Monday and Tuesday. They already tried it with early voting, but Trump's winning so bad they don't want to talk about it. See, it's hard to beat a landslide, but they've still got tricks up their sleeve. We'll be back. Stay with us. Hour number two straight ahead. You know, I'd love to say we just got 4 days left. But we all know they're going to try to contest it. They're going to try to steal it. I've got all the news here. The polls show Trump in rigged polls is 6 points ahead, 4 points ahead, 8 points ahead, 10 points ahead. Depending on the battleground state, 6 points ahead in Florida. They are crapping their little britches right now. And they are getting ready to pull out all the stops fraud-wise. I've been up late every night working. And so it's like a calm before the real storm hits. I am just super calm today. I'm normally just chomping at the bit, bouncing off the walls. I am super calm. Now, I only had a half cup of coffee this morning. It's because I take selenium. It gives me so much energy because it's key to electrochemical processes in the brain. I realized I haven't taken selenium in a couple of days, so I'm going to take, this is not a plug, I realized I was just doing it and forgot to take it during the 1 minute break, so now I'm plugging because it's out of necessity. I'm going to take my probiotic, I'm going to take my selenium from InfoWarsLife.com, and I'm going to take a Brain Force too, because I don't normally need, yeah, I wasn't planning this, I don't normally need Brain Force. I mean, like I said, taking selenium, I've even cut back on caffeine 90% probably. But then sometimes going off caffeine, I just suddenly get in like a doldrum. I mean, I got tons of energy, but compared to normal. And so right now I'm taking a Brain Force and I'm taking a probiotic, Biome Defense from InfoWarsLife.com. And then again, I don't know where it's gone. There it is. My selenium, BioTrue selenium from InfoWarsLife.com. I'm going to take this right now as well. I was just thinking, why not just plug on air since I was already about to take it during the break? Watch what happens. The next hour, Mighty Mouse. It's like the I'm strong to the finish because I eat my spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Doot, doot. You know, part of that is just being myself and being self-deprecating. Because pride goeth before a fall, and it's fun to act stupid sometimes, isn't it? Gallows humor, my friends, but I'm not going to mix being silly now with this important information, so I'll cover it when we come back from break and as I reset my mind. But, man, when you're reading about pedophile rings and Epstein and the Clintons and just at a certain point, I just want to, it's like, wow, could we just get some half-decent people in government that aren't total scum? And who aren't trying to start World War III and who aren't in love with radical Islamicists opening our border up. I mean, really, it goes to the psychology of these people that they're so outrageously unhappy. And Hillary, a lot of psychiatrists have pointed this out. I'll have Pachinik on, you know, just about how she only wants to be around really ugly people. Now, I'm not a crazy fake person where I just want to be around beautiful people. But with Hillary, it's known. Really ugly, really nasty, really weird people, really criminal people. She likes hanging around with pedophiles. She likes representing scum. She likes she likes not taking baths. She's just a big, stinking, horrible, nasty monster. And she is probably one of the greatest villains I've ever known of. And but again, she hides it all because she's this waddling, evil old woman. You know, it's supposedly okay because she's a woman. We have names for evil women. We call them witches. Alex Jones calls her a witch. I don't mean that literally. I mean it figuratively as an archetype. But I love how the media test markets all these attacks on us and then drops them immediately because all it does is boost Donald Trump's polls. We're not in the same old world anymore where you control things and you say what's normal and you get to criticize us. When you criticize us, our stock goes up. You are done. I know you still have the big paychecks and still think you're somebody in the MSM. You're not. You're a disgraced joke. And Donald Trump smelled that. He's always been a nationalist and a patriot and against NAFTA and GATT, but he's become dominantly that now and has gone through trial by fire and has come out after the battle with the metaphysical Balrog even stronger. He's no longer Donald Trump the gray, but Trump the white. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen. We're only 4 days out, and Donald Trump is Americana. Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. That there is a seismic shift, just like Brexit, the awakening to the true nature of planetary control. And once you force that debate out in the open and people realize that they've been kept in the dark and are being governed from afar, just as with our colonies in 1775 and 1776, the breakaway is as sure as night following day and so on and so forth. Here's part of an intro with Donald Trump.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. Americanism, not globalism. Americanism, not globalism.
The era of economic surrender will finally be over.
We will no longer surrender this country or its people to the false song of globalism.
They have gotten the political establishment and the media establishment to become pure, wanton henchmen of totalitarianism.
If you were a foreign power looking to weaken America, you couldn't do better than Hillary Clinton's economic agenda.
I think what the Chinese have done is really smart.
The skyscrapers went up in Beijing and many other cities around the world, while the factories and neighborhoods crumbled right here in Detroit.
It's all training us to accept less, lowering expectations, a post-industrial world, a new dark age. That's what the UN Biological Diversity Assessment 1996 calls for.
When we abandoned the policy of America first, we started rebuilding other countries instead of our own.
Not a world, Winston, that gets more beautiful and more technological and stronger. A world that gets uglier and stupider and more stunted.
The government should allow Hillary Clinton to become president of the United States.
I voted for Hillary Clinton.
Well, I voted for Hillary. I guess I have to since I'm working for her as well.
You want an image of the future, Winston? It's a boot stomping on a human face forever.
Muslims are peaceful and tolerant people and have nothing whatsoever to do
with terrorism.
Women are treated, discriminated against in all of these countries she took money against. Gays and lesbians are either executed or punished severely. They're mistreated. She claims to be their champion.
Don't look at me, Winston, and see the black circles around my eyes and see how ugly and weak I am, expressing myself and dying, and I torture people 18 hours a day, and I have a horrible life. That's the beauty of the satanic evil of the priest of power ripping apart humanity. We're here to hurt humans. We're here to suck your guts out.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance.
Well, I told the Clintons 2 weeks ago that, from my sources, that if they didn't start backing down and didn't stop trying to steal the election, that more info would be coming out dealing with sex, dealing with children. And you notice now that's coming out in the New York News. We've had guests on yesterday. The NYPD's got the information. This will destroy the Democratic Party. This will irrevocably annihilate you. But you tried to kill the country, didn't you? You tried for a full takeover. You were so naked. You were so arrogant that you openly had all these servers selling our secrets to the world. These were drop boxes to then corrupt other politicians and get them involved using secret servers and pseudonyms and nom de plumes to complete your corruption. Now, until 45 after, and we've got some breaking news coming then, we have William F. Jasper joining us to cover the election, what he thinks is coming, what's happening. He's the editor at thenewamerican.com. And I don't always introduce him this way because I like to do this for the average guest. It's important to know where we came from and what we've done. I've never been a member of the John Birch Society. It was set up in 1956, and it was set up by American patriots who discovered that we'd turned our back in China and put the communist Chinese in power in 1949. That's now been declassified, what, 13, 14 years ago. But the John Birch Society, with military people and others, began to go public. They got demonized. They got attacked. Back when mainstream media was like God in this country. Back when it was totally trusted. And if you go back to what they said back then, it was basically all accurate, on target. And that's where Barry Goldwater and everything else we've seen in Ron Paul came from. So when you hear the media say Donald Trump spouting Alex Jones information, he gets it from Alex Jones, I'd love to say that was true. And we've had conversations on air and off air, and Trump does agree with me on a lot of things because we're seeing the same thing. And he's advised by people like General Flynn, who understand how the real world works. This isn't like some political view we have that's our opinion. Global government's now out in the open. And it's exactly as the founders of the John Birch Society said it was back in the 1950s. And these people put everything they had into fighting this. Everything. They sold their companies, you name it. These are the folks are the reason we're even able to put on this defense now. But here's the good news. Even if they steal this from Trump, and he's an imperfect messenger, everybody is, I think he's going to win. This is the beginning of the end for global government. And they admit that in the Financial Times, in The Economist, in their publications. They are chicken with their head cut off, freaked out. Now, they admit authoritarianism might still work, but they've got to take the gloves off now, which makes it a lot harder. So the reason I bring up the John Birch Society is you have to understand, folks, our resistance to this started a long time ago in this country and other areas and is now a global phenomenon. And so if you think we're in trouble now, look at what 50, 60 years ago, almost no one knew about this. So we've come a long way. Most Americans know the Federal Reserve represents a bunch of private interests and isn't federal. Most Americans now know about global government. They know about NSA spying. They know about government picking winners and losers. They know about the uber rich wanting to make us poor. And once that paradigm shifts, the class warfare doesn't work anymore. So we're in a race right now, a race against tyranny. William F. Jasper, The New American Magazine, newamerican.com, great news site as well, joins us. There's so much to cover. I've got evidence of them to have early projections and how they're going to announce that Hillary's won early to turn folks away and try to sew it up. Tuesday afternoon, we've got other information we're going to get into. But the good news is Trump is surging in every poll, even polls that sample way more Democrats. They're in panic mode, and there is good elements of our government that are now leaking information. It's coming out. It was not the Russians. This is an incredible time to be alive. And so William F. Jasper is our guest. I kind of set the table there with this epic fight. But what is it like for you being involved for 30-something years, your parents, early members? You thought they were crazy, World War II vets, you know, saying that our government was working with communists. You investigated their claims, found out they were right. I mean, I'm kind of recapping your story, but you've been a member since you were, you know, a young man, to now see how we've been vindicated. My dad, you know, giving speeches when he was in high school and college about this, he's been vindicated. I mean, thank God for the folks that have been out there. And it's not about the credit, but it's understanding how now worldwide the movement the John Birch Society started is now the worldwide resistance, not in the actual organization, but in the spirit of it. Is that not accurate?
Well, I think it is, Alex, and I thank you very much. And a great deal of that can be credited to you. You've done an amazing job in the last couple of decades. Next month will be my 40th year in this fight. And so I have seen a lot of crazy, wild, and terrible things happening. And I have to say, this election cycle, this current cycle that we're in right now is the most amazing wild ride that we've ever experienced, with all the things that are happening, all the things that are coming out. And it is a very exciting time, and it's a very sobering and in many ways a frightful time, because so much is at stake. We are now down to the wire in this battle of nationalism, Americanism versus globalism. And we don't know exactly how that's going to come out, but we did not think weeks ago, months ago, that it was going to be this close. The way the media had stacked it, the insider globalist media had stacked it for Hillary, as you reported, as we reported this past June, at the Bilderberg summit, it was all stacked with Hillary Clinton's people, stacked against Trump, and stacked against the other big issue at that moment was the Brexit in the UK. And I think, and we reported and we said and we opined since then, that the way the Brexit vote came out in the UK in favor of exiting the EU, in spite of the Project Fear launched by the British Conservative Party, the Labour Party, the Liberal Democrat Party, a sweep of all the parties except for the UKIP, and with all of the media, all of the banks, all of the big globalist corporations, the establishment think tanks and establishment economists all say, warning the British people that the island would self-destruct and Godzilla would eat London if they voted for the Brexit. Nevertheless, against all of the polling, the British people surprised us all and came out in favor of the Brexit, in favor of leaving the EU, which has been a monstrous attack on their national sovereignty and the national sovereignty of all of the EU member nations. And so we said at the time, I said in my opinion pieces at the time, that this was a very sobering thing. And it was a very exciting thing for us, because it presaged what was likely to happen with the same odds in the Trump-Clinton matchup.
William F. Jasper is our guest, New American Magazine, newamerican.com. If Trump gets in, if they're unable to steal it, how will they counterstrike? Obviously, they've tried to now bring the UK down economically, but the people see through that, kind of like Hitler in the Blitz. It only hardened the Brits to fight harder. Now that global government's out in the open and they openly threaten to implode our economy and they openly threaten to do all these horrible things, you know, if we elect Donald Trump or burn down U.S. cities, it only illustrates the fact that we do have this alien foreign corporate system over us that is in the news financing Hollywood today to openly say white males are inherently bad and should be, quote, killed. I mean, the rhetoric of these people is beyond anything I ever even saw Marxists put out. It is the most virile.
Well, that's part of this whole culture wars, which is really the setup for all of the change of our whole system. If you capture the culture, that is the entertainment, the education, all of the methods and means of transmitting to the younger generation what this country is supposed to be about and the world view, you essentially have won. And that has been the principal PSYOPs attack of the communist end of the conspiracy from day one, going back over 100 years. And it's been the principal means by which the globalist insiders working together with communists have accomplished the same thing, assisting the transformation of our culture through entertainment, through education, through propaganda. You can convince one of the most potent examples of that, of course, is the acceptance by the younger generations now of homosexuality, something which a generation ago was so abhorrent that it wasn't even mentioned. But if you constantly on the network, television, sitcoms, soap operas, etc., present people with homosexuality, with perverse sexuality of all kinds, pornography, you're going to wear down the resistance to that. And that's what they have done. And the same thing with gender politics, with race politics. The very people who claim that they are against hate are the ones who are engendering hate. They're particularly engendering, and now, as you point out, coming right out in the open and demanding hate for European culture, Christian culture.
And it's mainly white people pushing it. And again, you know, they use these football issues of sex and things, they admit this, to divert off the financial thieving, the spying. We're all losing our rights. And they just get us all fighting with each other when we were all basically getting along before. But how do they square this idea of announcing world government, having the Pope push world government, global carbon taxes, you know, Time Magazine, Newsweek, the Financial Times of London? We need world government. It needs to be unelected for your own good. Carbon taxes. But then they separately say it doesn't exist. It's insane. If Donald Trump talks about the TPP, I mean, there was an article a few days ago in Bloomberg saying, yes, cities are passing laws for illegals to vote, and we should have illegals voting, but Trump's against it, and it doesn't exist. He's insane. They're actually writing articles that are, like, meant to be mentally ill now, where it says the illegals are voting, and we need to make more vote, but Trump's insane. They're not voting. I mean, world government's here.
The common sense American would go, okay, we're not supposed to be having illegal aliens vote, but when somebody makes a common sense proposal or passes legislation,
they scream racist
for voter identification. Then automatically you're a xenophobe, a racist.
Sure, but I'm asking you, you're a smart guy. There's this new thing where they go, we're setting up world government, but we'll call you racist if you say it exists. It's almost like they're trying to break us or something by openly engaging in nonsense. I mean, I'm seeing a new assault now of, like, nonsense.
Well, and that's one of the benefits that we have seen with Trump's ascendancy, is that he has called this political correctness, this brainwashing, this propaganda for what it is. And many people have been afraid to criticize anything because they're afraid of the racist label. They're afraid of being called hateful. They're afraid.
You're right. So his biggest thing is being brazen and getting us out of our comfort zones.
Yes. And so I was just at the United Nations the week before last. I've been a correspondent there for 30 years. They hate me. I hate them. That's one hate I will admit to. But they frequently try to stop me from being accredited there. I have been accredited there for 3 decades.
Yeah, that's a perennial deal. They try to kick you out or stop you.
Right. And I don't know whether they're going to accredit me this time. They've gone through a new procedure. And the day before I arrived there, I read a story in the Canadian Financial Press that they had instituted a new accreditation process for alternative media for those who represent advocacy positions. So I'm sure they're going to give me a tough time about getting accredited. But while I was there in New York at the UN, we had just gotten a new Secretary General, Antonio Guterres, and he's a buddy of Hillary Clinton's and Bill Clinton's. He was the president of the Socialist International, and the Socialist International proudly traces its lineage back to Karl Marx. It is the largest organization of communist and socialist organizations. He's the former prime minister of Portugal, president of the Socialist International. Now he's the Secretary General of the UN. Prior to that, He was the man in charge of designing the refugee program that flooded Europe and is trying to flood the United States. He worked there with Peter Sutherland, the chairman of Global Sachs International, and with Anthony Lake, the Institute.
And again, the biggest banks, what the John Birch Society has done, it was the first to do, was, and then Barry Goldwater was a senator, obviously, was in there and able to see the documents and confirm what you were saying, what your parents were saying, others were saying, is that, and what Welch was saying, obviously, was that the ultra-rich want to get rid of a free market and have a monopoly, as John D. said, competition's a sin, and that's why they're always caught running the communists, running the socialists, running the Russian Revolution. It's a plague. I mean, don't we almost have to apologize to the Russians being from the U.S. or England because our country's money and people contributed to the overthrow of Russia?
Well, absolutely. And again, we want to make a distinction between the Russians and the communist regimes that ruled them. It was not Russians per se. In fact, most of the Bolsheviks, the communists who went in to effect the Bolshevik Revolution, were non-Russians.
Yeah, they were from New York and London.
Right. And so this is the thing that many people on both the right and left don't understand. Many of the Bernie Sanders people who think that Bernie Sanders was opposing Wall Street, that he's an anti-Wall Street guy, just like Hillary Clinton. Some of them see through Hillary because it's very obvious. She takes huge cash fees from
She's Goldman the biggest Sachs, Wall Street candidate ever.
BlackRock, J.P. Morgan Chase, Citibank, etc. Yeah, she's the most connected Wall Street funded politician ever. And yet, she is comfortable and happy with the top 1% of the top 1%. And yet she uses this populist rhetoric, this working class appeal.
She even talks in fake hick accents. She'll talk to a Hispanic group and put on a weird accent. She showed up at a black group and goes, look, soul food. Or she shows up at a Hispanic group and goes, look, hot sauce. And then she goes, how you doing there today? When she's in Kentucky. I mean, talk about a fake.
But this is what we're dealing with at the highest levels, complete phonies and monsters who are posing as champions of the people while they are actually working to concentrate, centralize all power. And this is where you see the key important issue with the globalists and the communist socialists cooperating. What do both of them want? They both want total power, concentrating political, economic, social power all in the hands of an oligarchy, a few. That's what you had in the communist countries and still have in the communist countries. That's what we are getting more and more here as our free market, free enterprise system, what's left of it, is eroded and destroyed piece by piece.
And let me just add, William F. Jasper is joining us, the editor-in-chief at the New American Magazine, the preeminent publication everybody should subscribe to, especially to give to people. If, hey, you want to know what's really going on? Read this. I mean, you talk about Veritas, it's it. And when we come back from break, sir, I want to just ask you in the final segment we have, what the world will look like if they succeed? Because you, unlike anybody else, have studied their own documents, their own admissions, what they want to set up. And it's so nightmarish that I get why people think we're conspiracy theorists, because this sounds insane. But if you look at what Hitler wanted to do or what the Soviets wanted to do and other, you know, command and control utopians, it's always over the top unbelievable. And that's why each generation gets caught by it, because the average person doesn't think like this. So we'll come back with William F. Jasper in a final segment. Then I've got big breaking news. And into the third hour today, Colonel Schaefer, who blew the whistle on Hillary and Obama being behind ISIS and Al-Qaeda, he's going to join us with the biggest intel yet about what's happening currently in the world and surprises. Surprises are coming today and the next few days, Infowars.com. 4 days out. Stay with us. Again, I want to be very clear here. I don't give credit to people just because people want credit. I know William F. Jasper and the John Birch Society does in the New American Magazine. We have to recognize the people that have been fighting a long time against this tyranny and who've gone through hell and who've been proven right. Somebody else I want to point out who is the most valuable player in this fight against globalism and who, time after time, is who breaks through the line to get Julian Assange's information out or to get Donald Trump early on out there or to get InfoWars out there. I just had my IT people run in here with a laptop and they said, look at this. We had like five times our record traffic a few days ago. Look at this. Speaking of drudgereport.com, they said we are having way more than eight times our previous record traffic listening to the audio streams and watching the video, which is a small part of our audience, but still huge, from the Drudge link. And see, that's what Matt Drudge is doing. We're not paying for that. Matt Drudge is just linking to everybody that's fighting because we're in a war. So what you do is you go to drudgereport.com, you click on the sponsors and support Drudge because it's symbiotic. You go back to the Clinton Foundation, and not the new current one or the global initiative, the even bigger one, the third incarnation that's got tens of billions coming into it. But if you go back to their original library, they got the documents from the Clintons when they first got in 93. And it's all about shut down competition. Don't let a new media develop. Don't, you know, people sell books or people fund their new media. We've got to go after them and shut them down and use the IRS and use the media and call them conspiracy theorists because that'll produce an economy of outside ideas. Well, you failed. You failed. And you failed to stop DrudgeReport.com, and you failed to stop the New American Magazine. You failed to stop InfoWars. You failed. And so this is a big deal. And I'm not trying to have a celebration here 4 days out from the election. But I'm telling you, folks, we've gone from not even on the map fighting this 50 years ago to now globally, secession from the corporations and big mega banks is the hottest thing out there. And they've had Washington Post articles and New York Times articles and Austin American Statesman articles where they go, oh, my God, InfoWars gets more traffic than CNN and National Review combined. What are we going to do? And I'm like, you just now noticed this? Drudge is getting 15 times the traffic we are. It's just before they would announce Drudge was over because the bigger he got, it shows their attempt to sell a delusion. And William F. Jasper, getting back to you and talking about what the stakes are if we lose, because certainly the empire is going to strike back. But there's an intellectual victory. They're still in control, though, financially. So how do we get through that? But just do you concur or do you disagree? I mean, we should all just pause for a moment and say mainstream media is collapsing. Free thinking is exploding. Renaissance is being rediscovered. I mean, this is a magic moment.
Well, that is why, Alex, there was such a big battle over the last couple of years about control of the control of the Internet. You know, and that battle is not finished yet. The United Nations, the globalists have tried to put the United Nations in charge of the Internet. That did not work. Even many on the left said, hey, wait a second. The United Nations.
So now it's kind of partially because of folks fighting. It's now kind of in limbo.
Right. So now they've taken a transition to that. We're going to go through this nebulous icon corporation. It's not spelt out, and we're going to put it there. But ultimately, the game plan is the same. They will have a global entity under the United Nations controlling it. And of course, it'd be the oligarchy, the one worlders who would be really.
And a top Supreme Court justice told Matt Drudge a year ago that is the plan.
Yes, that's been the plan all along, and we've been reporting from those UN summits on the internet that's precisely what they're planning.
And the Soros WikiLeaks show that he says we've just got to shut down our competition by UN takeover of the web. So we have them admitting that's their plan. So what do we do?
Right. So what we have to do is exponentially increase all of our reach over the internet. Get this information out to stop them from moving ahead with this. What we have in the next few days are a number of different scenarios. I'm sure you've played some of them out. If Trump wins in the election, if they're not able to steal it with election machinery, with the electronic voting, then we know that quite a number of things are going to happen. We will have the Black Lives Matter, La Raza folks, creating riots in the streets, social turmoil.
That was my next question. What happens if Trump does get in? I mean, you got one of the best crystal balls out there.
Well, that's almost a given that would happen.
How do we respond then?
Well, that would not be sufficient to bring down our country. We'll have to wait it out. Obviously, we're going to have to try to. That's why the Second Amendment is so important. If you have widespread rioting, the citizens themselves, armed citizens, will protect it and stop it from going on. I was in the L.A. riots down there, and in those black neighborhoods where the rioters didn't destroy the neighborhoods, it was because the black citizens there in South Central L.A. came out with their guns.
That's right. The media would not show that.
No, you didn't see that. It was the Koreans and the Mexicans and the black people in South Central that protected their own neighborhoods. They barricaded their streets. And the mobs, the rioters that were coming down.
I've always noticed the media is very racist. They claim they love black people, but they never show black people doing the right thing, which they do almost all the time, just like everybody else does. They show the bad examples to kind of promote that and then say that's heroic. But I remember the reports. It was a lot of black folks standing up to the rioting, but they would never show that.
That's why minorities, racial minorities, religious minorities, are the ones who should most embrace the Second Amendment. That's their final protection. When you have a majority or a mob coming after you and the police can't be there or the police are nowhere in sight, you're on your own and you better be able to protect yourself. So for Asian Americans, Black Americans, Hispanic Americans, the Second Amendment is one of their
Hitler's a great example, taking the Jews' guns, putting them in ghettos. I mean, first you take the guns of who you're going to oppress.
Well, we know that beyond that, we already have set up for this election. We have OSCE and UN monitors coming in.
That's where I wanted to go next. I mean, they've been here a few of them before. Reuters reported a tenfold increase. So they're saying Trump's insane. It doesn't exist. There's no fraud. But the biggest fraud ever is here. So we've got to have the OECD's paramilitary security force here.
Well, and that's part of the plan. They haven't gotten to that point yet, but in other countries around the world, they have used the claim of ungovernability to justify bringing in the blue.
That's where I was going. There's a level even beyond what we're seeing here.
Yes, and at this point, that would be very difficult for them to do because we still have a couple hundred million armed Americans. There are increasingly, 50 years ago when the John Birch Society launched the Get Us Out of the United Nations campaign, a lot of people thought that they were crazy. I did at the time when I was in college until I started studying their materials. And I said,
briefly tell that story about your parents, who were World War II vets, if I remember correctly. And then you're crazy. You look at the material and you were a smart student in college. You're like, whoa, this is real.
Yeah, and I think anyone who really will look at the information, for instance, a lot of the material that you're presenting here, people haven't heard of before until they said, but the public records are out there. Behind me is a small part of my library. Most of the information that we have comes from public sources. Like most media, we have to use inside sources who are anonymous within government agencies or within corporations, et cetera. But most of the most damning material we get from public source materials. They can be checked. They can be verified. And that's all we're asking people to do is, look, your liberty is at stake. Your future is at stake. Your children's lives, fortunes, and liberties are at stake. Let's put aside all of this entertaining of ourselves to death and get serious about saving our country and saving our civilization.
I agree. And people are finding out it's fun to be informed. It's fun to be involved. I mean, I'm seeing the awakening. It was like a 1 on a Richter scale 5 years ago. It's like a 10 right now. I mean, it is exceedingly strong. That's got to be really, really panicking with social engineers.
Well, and that it is invigorating, and particularly for men, it's a manly thing to be involved in taking control of your life, of your community, of your family. It's a terribly emasculating and wimpy thing for men to just be concerning themselves with sports and other movies and video games while their civilization is being destroyed. So the manly thing to do is to roll up your sleeves and jump in, educate yourself.
And that's why we see the colleges and the big money at total war against men, saying masculinity, leadership, strength is a bad thing. They're trying to teach women that. Women instinctively know that's a load of manure.
Well, and this is one of the things that's encouraging that we're seeing here is that people are coming out of, as you know, I was not an early supporter of Trump. We don't endorse people. We don't publicly endorse anybody. I still have my reservations about Trump. He's an imperfect candidate. But many of the things that you have pointed out, we have noted as well. We take our time in analyzing these things, and we've seen the American people fooled many times before by politicians who claim, like Jimmy Carter, that he's an outsider and we need to change and get rid of
Bush wasn't going to be the world super cop. But I mean, with Trump, the fear of the elite's real. I know the inside baseball. Trump is so pigheaded and does love America and doesn't like being screwed over by other elites. He sees himself as an underdog. He relishes defeating these people. They've got his M.O., Mr. Jasper. That's why they're so scared.
I have been convinced as we studied it more and more that the opposition was not just shadow boxing. The overwhelming anti-Trump forces in both Republican and Democratic administrations, the Council on Foreign Relations, Trilateral, Bilderberg, One World Elites have just come down on him like even more than they did against Goldwater. The same thing that we experienced over the last 50 years.
And so what's your prime analysis? They know he's imperfect, but he's a man. He's a bull. He does love the country. He's going at him. They know he will never back down. That's why they're scared.
Right. And so this brings us another scenario, and that is, should Trump win the election, what happens to him? As you know, there have been many assassinations throughout history. We're talking about a huge impetus, a huge motive on the part of those who...
Well, I'll tell you, he knows that, and he doesn't want that, but quite frankly, he has no fear. I mean, the guy...
Well, and that is what anyone taking this position has to face up to, because if you have that fear going in, you really shouldn't be in this race. You have to expect that.
I hear you. Well, William F. Jasper, I want to invite you back up for a full hour very, very soon. Even next week, if you've got time, we're going to do 52 hours live broadcast kicking off Monday. Thank you so much for your great work. What a historical time to be alive. And it's great to just be able to recognize how far we've come thanks to those Americans in the 50s, I mean, who just had the... Spend 60 seconds on that. How did the founders of the John Birch Society get it so right? I mean, just dead on.
Well, first of all, the credit goes primarily, overwhelmingly, to Robert Welch himself. He was a brilliant man. He was a child prodigy who was reading at the age of 3 and was phenomenally intelligent. But he surrounded himself with a number of other very brilliant men, but men who had experience in the military, in business, in finance, in academia. Guys such as Ludwig von Mises and Henry Hazlitt and many other experts in geopolitics. And he was wise enough to know that one person cannot know everything. And they trusted him because of his integrity and of his brilliance and knowledge. And so he put together this core group of people. And this was right at a time when Americans were realizing, hey, something's terribly wrong. Communists are taking over one country after another. This is like something the world had never seen before, a global conquest, global slaughter, massacre, genocide on a scale never seen before. And it was being aided at every step by people in our own government.
And Welch, with the military, the Patriots, discovered that it was mega...
Not only the Alger Hisses and those types,
mega bankers,
but banking and business people. And so he was able to get enough people together, and they finally began to make a big enough impact that all of the establishment and the communist and globalist media and academia just came down on them. But we've survived.
And the emergency message got out. We held off the globalists a long time. And now every time they try to complete their work, it just proves us right that it blows up again. What an amazing thing you guys have done. And I see that as a testament. That's why I don't care about being demonized or lied about. I know I'm doing the right thing. And I know in history, we're standing up for what's right. That's why I don't care what a bunch of collaborators and enemy media say. In fact, I'd like to invite you sometime to town if you'd like to come. Maybe make a documentary for online with the history of the John Birch Society and the New American Magazine, because it's a blueprint for victory into other countries and into the future. We'll always face these type of criminal operations. We're not trying to build a utopia here. We're just trying to build a free market. And I want to salute you, my friend.
Well, thank you, Alex. My pleasure.
I mean, folks, it just gives me chills. You read the stuff Welch wrote in the 50s and everything. I mean, they say basically that guy could like predict the future. He was so smart, but he understood it. He had the analysis, and then as he found out about it, all these generals and people in Congress came to him and said, "How do you know this? This is what's happening." And then he said, "Well, I could just see it." And they're like, "Yeah, that's what's going on." And God gives us these type of people. And there's people out there right now. And look, Donald Trump's not perfect. We all know that. But he is a real man. He loves this country. He wants to take the shackles off. He doesn't want to have war with Russia because they've done nothing with us. China's in our face. He's like, okay, you want some? The Islamists want to piss all over us? He's ready to stand up to them. Russia does something to Trump, he'll stand up. That's one false flag they might pull, is stir some stuff up with Russia to try to get Trump after Russia. So Trump's got his problems because he's so real that he can be manipulated, but any of us can. The point is that this is an epic battle taking place. It's historical, and I'm just honored to be here. Now, Anthony Gucciardi's here. I drug him in here because we have developed now, what is this, like our 20th product, BioPCA hair and nails formula. This is the best-selling formula, not this formula, but formulas similar to it, of all the different supplements out there. We've spent a long time coming out with this. I want it to be very inexpensive, but the highest quality. And obviously, if it makes your nails and your skin and your hair healthier, it's everything else. But if you want that glow, we've developed it, $29.95. Competitors.
Actually, it's $19.95.
Oh, we're discounting it out of the gates.
Yep.
I forgot that. So this is the best deal we've ever put out. And especially for women and other folks. Tell us about it, Anthony. We're going to go to break in a minute, but start telling us about it.
You know, briefly, look, let's just say it like this. You talk to people in the industry, and they say, we can't believe what you're doing, because they put a bunch of junk into something for comparatively way more pricing. We can go over some products. My dermatologist friend said, this is absurd. For example, you have just silica, which is one of the ingredients in this. One of the ingredients, we have hit the labels taken off, obviously. $28 for just one of the ingredients we have. We have 14 different ingredients, proprietary formula.
We got to tape a whole presentation on this.
I mean, it's endless amounts of information.
You're showing what you get from a dermatologist.
Yes.
Where just one ingredient, the same dose, is more.
$28 to $35.
Than what we've got. Now, coming up when I start the next hour, I'm going to get into, will Hillary break? Will Hillary drop out as all this indictment news comes out and reports of sex slaves and children all connected to this new probe in New York? With the expansion of Wienergate and just all the massing total proof that she lied to Congress and lied to everybody else, and was the paper play was much, much worse. They've got her. But are they crazy enough? This is so historic and so dangerous. Are they crazy enough to start a war or civil unrest? I mean, who knows? We're 4 days out. It's an incredible time to be alive. It is totally insane. And it is the products we sell here that have funded this independent organization. This is now the model of more independent media to just direct sell the public. And that's what other liberty organizations should just do, I suggest, is bypass advertising altogether, bring folks really high-quality products that you develop, or we just private label what's already a bestseller. We've kind of done that with this. We've gone out and found all the best sellers, the highest-quality organic companies. That's kind of my model. Like Knockout is 9 different known compounds, valerian root, L-tryptophan, melatonin. The dose in it of melatonin is the dose that in most bottles is $19.95. And then you get 8 other compounds in it. I mean, that's crazy because they mark stuff up 5 to 7 times. We don't do that. So, Anthony, it's FTC and other laws. We have to cover up competitors' names and labels. We're not supposed to show them. We show ours. Okay, whatever. But everybody knows this. Go over what's in our product versus all the stuff people have to take to get the same thing.
Well, it's BioPCA. It's the hair and nails formula, but it's so much more than that. And as always, you know, you can only say certain things about the products. But like I was talking about, people in the industry, we talk to them all the time, heads of major manufacturing companies and things like that. And they're always saying, like,
your girlfriend's an esthetician. She can't believe what a good
deal. Right. And I have a good dermatologist friend, too. He was showing me some of these. I mean, for example, this has biotin, which was one of the best for hair and nails. I mean, it's just proven over and over again to grow and strengthen nails, et cetera. But we're under attack. And InfoWars Life is all about fighting back. And when you take a shower, it is literally giving toxic junk into your skin. It's messing with your hair. The shampoo you use is junk. It's all just crap, okay? And it's time to actually fight back and do something about it. And we put the best stuff in here. It's a proprietary formula with collagen, enzymes, biotin, vitamins, zinc, orotate, the best forms of it. But there's 10,000, as comparison, 10,000 micrograms of biotin in this, right? In 2 pills. Now, let's compare. This is a $48 product that dermatologists will sell, and it only has 3,000 micrograms of biotin. Okay, so it's about 4
That's
times less.
The industry tells us, they $50. Go, hey, nobody does what you do. They just do marketing. I'm like, why not really have badass supplements?
Exactly. And
I mean, I treat you like I want to be treated. People say they're superstitious. I'm not superstitious about broken mirrors or Friday the 13th. I'm superstitious about, I better treat you like I want to be treated.
Not screw
I better tell
over.
You everything I'm up to. It's got 100% markup, or this one's a little bit less, but it's discounted like it's 50% right now. But the point is, we're funding our operation. That's enough. It's not that profit's bad. It's that I just don't get 7 times markup being the average and then giving people crap.
Well, and it's and it,
explain
it's a lot
that
of junk
to people.
There, though,
this
too.
Has way less than it's $48. And ours is 9. That's one ingredient.
Look, this is also the dermatologist said, well, look, you got to look at this other stuff. Silica, which is what we have, is from bamboo extract. A lot of it's synthetic junk. $35. This is just one ingredient in our product. They're selling it for $35, and this is a top seller. Okay? So, look, we're not going to screw people. So this is more than just the product itself also, which is great.
And we're not even differentiating. I can't believe the industry's like this.
And this is from people that have told me
they just can't help but put only a little bit and then way overcharge because they make more money instead of just saying, I want to give them the best price I can and then dominate and then get all the sales.
Exactly.
Which I didn't even do from a greedy position. I always put out my videos for free. Always said you can make copies. People said, oh, that's really smart marketing. That's why you went so viral. I didn't think that. I wanted to expose stuff, but that's why we were successful. And they just don't get it, Anthony.
And why not support something meaningful you believe in, right? Doesn't mean you have to agree 100% with everything InfoWars does, but why not actually spend as much as you're going to spend on Starbucks to do something that's actually
Look, there are other supplement companies out there, and that's what we get private label from, that really do sell you super high quality
stuff. Yeah, of course, there's other great stuff out there.
And then they mark up 150%, we mark up 100%, and that's how we dominate the market. Yep. I mean, take Child East. That's been around 30 years. It's a top product. You know, under another name, sold at Whole Foods. We just discounted. InfoWarsLife.com. Get the new product, BioPCA, Hair and Nails Formula, or 888-253-3139. Do a few more minutes on this, and I'm going to get to the latest developments. Boy, I tell you, this is huge. Civilization is based on win-win. Conquest is based on conquest. And after you sack the city, in a couple days, there's no cool fountains, there's no cool hot baths, there's no cool... You know, restaurants, there's no cool, temples, there's nothing. You've wrecked the civilization. Okay, you sacked it, you took control of it, you're like cancer, you killed it. And we've always had a balance, it's not a good balance, but there's always been a balance between tyranny and liberty, between renaissance and conquest. And the globalists claimed, oh, we're bringing in the end of conquest, we're going to domesticate you, it's the opposite, that's just so they can prey on us and have the ultimate conquest over the species. The globalists acting like they're aliens or something. I mean, this is the craziest mental illness I've ever seen. But, of course, you look at the elites. They have the most unhappy kids, highest rates of suicide. They're not happy. It's blowing back on them. They think they're insulated from pissing on everybody.
No, it's like at every level, how much are you getting screwed, right? At every level, if you think about the reality of it, we're talking about health, so we'll get into this for a second. Someone goes to a store, and I was at CVS the other day. I saw someone checking out with a bowl of like ramen noodles and a Miller Lite, okay? And then they say, oh, what are you up to? And he goes, this is my dinner. And it was like $1, okay? Now, these people want to save money. People buy cheap stuff, right? But guess what? It's the corporations and government bodies that allow the absolute junk to be in it in the first place.
They actuary that to lower the quality of everything so you don't recognize and demand quality, and they write white papers admitting it. Here's a perfect example. In the 60s, the McDonald's con artist, there's a movie coming out about him, he said, we won't need people to clean up. We'll just put thank you and peer pressure, throw your thing away, claiming it keeps prices down. Instead, it stops entry-level people and creates a culture where everything's dirty and falling apart. It's the same deal. We get what we demand. We take care of old people. We hire 10 people. We don't not take care of grandma and then hire 10 people like Bill Gates says. He says, kill grandma, we'll hire 10 teachers. Bull crap. A guy that wants to kill your grandmother ain't going to take care of you, you dumb moron. Knock you upside your head.
Exactly. It's like being honorable is what actually happens and actually grows society.
Being honorable builds incredible civilizations.
And empowering other people.
But then it creates spoiled brats.
Yeah.
So how do you fix that paradox?
Well, I don't know how to fix paradox because the whole concept is now like, look, it used to be, we've talked about this before. Okay, you had to hunt for your food and you had to like go out and kill bears and defend yourself and build villages.
And those were noble
civilizations.
People.
And now it's like you're offended on Twitter and that's just as big of a deal to most people, right? So it's like as we've progressed so deeply and so greatly, we've also fallen into complete just a shell of our
family. As we have more information than ever.
Yeah.
The average trendy says there's no world government because NPR said so.
I think it's because we believe in this lie. I think we believe in the lie that basically, you know, it turns into it's like a farm, right? Instead of like actually cultivating ideas and growing things, it's true that people are actually now more treated like cattle because as we have this wealth and rich society, whatever you want to call it, which is all kind of in shambles now too. It's whoever is the most screwed up can dominate it. It's whoever is the most corrupt, whoever wants to milk the most people and like screw over everybody. But then we have someone like Hillary Clinton, who's the epitome and embodiment of all of that. And somehow.
And then she lectures us how we're greedy and bad because we want to build companies and hire people.
But we're bad for even talking about her issues and her crimes, her true crimes against
humanity. Well, she's a woman. And again, they try that thing. Briefly, because I got you in there to plug this. This really, you've been so excited about this last year, developing and getting with all the big organic producers, coming out with one of the biggest private organic firms in the country makes this. I mean, I'm really proud of this product. If somebody wants the ultimate hair, nails, skin formula, BioPCA, $19.95. I thought it was $39.95. I mean, and I guess we're normally discounting down to
$29.95. Yeah, we actually have introductory pricing right now, $19.95. Because
so that's all. That's, I keep saying I have 100% markup. That's not even 50%.
No, no. It's because.
So this is introductory. You're the one running all this stuff. So
all this is the epitome of everything you just said. Instead of screwing people over, instead of giving them junk, we're going to give them the actual best stuff for the lowest prices. It's not BS. It's not some scam thing like, oh, we're going to lowest prices. It's the real deal. And that's why we're impassioned about it. And that's where.
Well, that's our religion.
Yeah.
And then we want you to go show this to dermatologists and people around you. They're going to go, what the hell? This was $19.95. Because I thought we had 100% markup at $39 and we were going off to $29. I didn't know. I missed it. You guys went to $19.95?
Yep.
Okay. Well, then this is like almost at cost, folks. So it's a loss leader introduction. We're so excited about it. InfoWarsLife.com. Thank you, Anthony. That's amazing.
Thank you.
How long this is going to last, though? Well, one of the best parts of having this job is I get to talk to great Americans like Lieutenant Colonel Tony Schaefer, who still advises Congress and does a lot of other things that are obviously not public, but it's just a super patriot who, back after 9/11, testified to Congress in private and then also in public about how there was a stand down to not kill bin Laden and a 9/11 stand down, basically. And Sybil Evans came out and backed up what he said. He went through a lot. They tried to prosecute him. That turned out to be false. He smiled through the whole thing, never really complained. He's a best-selling author. And he, day one, along with our other sources, he didn't give us classified info, but he pointed us where to look. He got a lot of heat for that. He came out and exposed what really happened at Benghazi and what he said 4 years ago here on the broadcast turned out to be dead on. So we'll give you his website, his Twitter, his Facebook, and more. But he's just one of the visible patriots who ran the army-wide program against Al-Qaeda. He's one of the visible people, like an iceberg tip, out there in the different military groups and the different agencies that are patriots. And I've always said our government's our biggest problem and our best asset in that America's still there. Bill of Rights is still there. Good people are still there. It's special interests that have hijacked the country that are the problem. But on average, it's our military. I'm not lionizing them. It's just a fact. That is the most awake and aware of what's happening. And it's our military that said no to backing ISIS and Al-Qaeda and has now basically forced a program to engage them, and they're being defeated. A lot of that's, you know, super secret, and it's very, very fluid. But we have seen the chairman of the Joint Chiefs come out and say, we could put up a no-fly zone, but that'll cause World War III. So we've got a lot of jockeying going on with Obama and Hillary with the election 4 days out. I appreciate him coming on to tell us as much as he can that isn't classified off open source of, because I get really concerned that they might pull something as a distraction with this election. They might, they've been saber rattling with Russia, who I know 4 years after he told us about it, Cy Hirsch, Pulitzer Prize winner, came out and was military to military, was the headline in the London Review of Books and the New Yorker magazine about how our military, it didn't engage in mutiny. It just ignored Obama and Hillary and just did not aid ISIS and Al-Qaeda and gave Russia the intel. Obama was faced to get behind it after he was embarrassed. This is unprecedented. Talk about books should be written. No one really knows about this. So Colonel Schaefer has been at the heart of this from the beginning. He doesn't like to say that. He doesn't want the attention because they come after him. But again, he's one of those people like you talk about with Steve Pachinik, Dr. Pachinik, coming out and speaking out about the soft counter coup against the globalists trying to take over this country. So, my friend, good to have you on. I appreciate all you've done.
Oh, Alex, thank you for having me. It's good, always an honor to speak to you. And look, you're spot on. I think there are patriots amongst us who are trying to do the best they can. And ironically, as you mentioned, regarding Able Danger, yes, those who served in the project have quietly gone back into service and are doing everything they can to protect the country. I'm one of those like they. I don't believe there's an expiration date on our oath of office. And I think once you take that oath, it's kind of a commitment to life and for life, and you've got to take it seriously. And to your point, since we last spoke, I was over in England at the University of Warwick on a panel on something called Question Time with Suzanne Evans, by the way, who's the spokesman for the Brexit movement. And one of the notable things about my visit there and about the whole Brexit situation is I think there's some deep parallels that resulted from the Brexit vote and the people of England saying enough is enough of this global idea and lack of accountability. We don't believe we should be, ruled by people on the continent who are not accountable to our needs. So I'd like to believe that the very thing you said is that there's an effort for people to recognize that their freedoms, their ideals, the culture we live in, where we teach independent thought, independent action, but accountability of action is being lost in this larger attempt to establish essentially a global perspective on everything. And I think, again, the Brexit issue, the Brexit vote, went in the way of the independent-minded. And I think we are now facing a very similar set of choices between Ms. Clinton, who is clearly pro-open borders, pro-world government, lack of accountability. I mean, I don't know of anyone who's been less accountable in their entire life than Ms. Clinton, versus Donald Trump, who I think is someone who's actually had to be someone who's worked, who's developed, who's seen results from his own sweat equity, and has actually, his success is ingrained, is built into the landscape of New York, Washington, and America. So it's a very clear choice here to be made, and I think it's one the American people must make very carefully.
Now, looking at this, you obviously bucked the system early on to expose what happened and were able to survive it. Most can't. You were a trailblazer in that. Looking now, I was told a week before this latest FBI probe by a former high-level CIA operative, I'll just leave it at that, but even beyond that, even deep state, and they said, watch, it's going to be reopened. The FBI is in rebellion. We already knew that, but he said, watch, the next week it happened. He said, then watch what happens with the NYPD and with this whole situation with Wiener. It ties into Epstein, and I'm seeing it all happen. And quite frankly, I don't want to say it's frightening, but to really realize this isn't talk, this is a real move by patriots to let Hillary and the globalists know, look, you better watch out. We're going to bring everything out. And I'm told there's even worse stuff they're about to bring out. So I'm just wondering what these globalists that have hijacked the country are going to do when they're faced down by people that aren't scared of them and are basically calling their bluff. I mean, because this is just what I'm told is there is a literal war going on inside the government right now. And people that told me this, I'm now seeing it manifest. I mean, it's confirmed.
Well, Alex, we talked about this in our last interview with my book talking about this very issue 4 years ago that it was coming. So, yeah, I think several groups, and I'm not unique. I mean, I'm one of the folks, I think, who picked up on this trend early, that there's a great deal of people who have recognized this slow boiling frog effect of the loss of our rights, this overabundance of taxation, this overabundance of control. And look, I don't know if your audience is aware of this. I actually have a degree in environmental studies. I'm one of the few conservatives who actually has taken the time to study what the left puts out regarding climate change and that sort of thing. And it's a complete grab of control. It's all about grabbing control, not saving humanity. So I think there's been a movement behind the scenes, both at the large level and the small level, of people who have taken the oath of office and are taking their responsibilities very seriously. So to your point regarding NYPD, regarding the Federal Bureau of Investigation's work, other things behind the scenes, there are a lot of people who know exactly what's going on. And Alex, this WikiLeaks thing, this ain't the Russians. I think people start, Judge Napolitano, my friend Judge Napolitano, did a video, which I'll refer to you all to look at, where he talks about he believes that the source of all this is actually retired members of our own government.
Well, I've been told by William Binney 6 months ago, the former head of technical NSA, that he knows that's the case. Now the former British ambassador was at a meeting in the U.S. and was actually told who did it. So I mean, I know we don't want to actually let out who's done it, because I've talked to folks that actually know who, but let me bring this up, because why, and I'm not saying this because you were in the Army or in the Army, and the other services are great, but why is it over and over again the Army, in this whole internal deal, seems to be the main group resisting the globalist takeover? I mean, out of all the groups doing it, it does seem to be the Army and then also Defense Intelligence as a whole and General Flynn are at the heart of this resistance?
Well, you know, I got to tell you, it's not just the Army. I think the Marines are behind this a lot more than people acknowledge. The Marines are a little bit smaller, and they're doing what they can. But
well, look at Smedley Butler, absolutely.
Right. So I think what we've seen here is that, let me speak philosophically for a moment. Warriors truly seek not to go to war. I think we are all very reluctant, especially those who have seen the havoc and death which comes both to innocent and guilty in war. And so I think all of us have recognized the need to try to forego and prevent conflict rather than embrace it. And once you've come to that as an understanding, you see politicians like Hillary Clinton, who are the first to try to use the military for purposes of political
gain. And then
she
makes jokes about it.
Absolutely. So I think you see both the brother in arms concept of all of us who have come through this trial by fire, working to establish work, which I believe is in the best interest of the American people. I'm sorry, Ms. Clinton does not speak for the American people. She does not speak for working together. She actually works to be very divisive, very dismissive as well, of the idea of doing the right thing for the American people. So I think you see this, it's like a tide of concern, a group of concerned veterans, concerned military officers who have always recognized it is our responsibility to defend the country. And let me say this in parallel. Both the Egyptian military and the Pakistani military have been essentially set aside and designed to be the protectors of those constitutions. The Egyptians, as we saw, have defended their government several times against the extremists. I mean, they removed President Morsi from power because he was.
And that's my next point. Why would Hillary and Obama, on record and CNN, all back the Muslim Brotherhood, that's basically Al Qaeda light, to blow up hundreds of churches, to attack the government, to destroy their economy? Why would we remove our allies there? What is behind this?
Well, that's an excellent question. I just came out of a meeting. I'm literally in the same room I was in the meeting regarding the Muslim Brotherhood as being a primary topic. Look, the Muslim Brotherhood is a terrorist organization. I met with Egyptian Chief of Intelligence General Al-Tuhimi on this back in 2013. And Alex, he made the point brilliantly that the Muslim Brotherhood is not simply an Egyptian problem. It is a global problem. And they are the underlying foundation for Al-Qaeda and ISIS and other extremist groups. They simply...
That's right. They're the recruiting and funding arm, and they're the main group, from my research, if I'm wrong, you're the world expert. Aren't they the main group behind the invasion of Africa?
Yeah, absolutely. They are doing everything they can to destabilize central government. So when we recognize this, and when you see Ms. Clinton and Mr. Obama warming up to them, you need to ask the hard questions. We've asked these hard questions. Members of Congress, I deal with my friend Louis Gohmert all the time on this. Louis is completely correct in his assessment that there are issues that we have to defend and work that are literally...
Sure. Well, Colonel Schaefer, let's expand on that. I mean, Google brags that 5 years ago they helped quarterback with the intelligence, with the electronic signals to manipulate and fund the Arab Spring and launch it. So who are the elements in our government? I know you know this, so I'd like you to talk about it, that are actually behind a Muslim Brotherhood takeover of the Middle East, allied with Saudi Arabia. What type of insane group does that?
One of the most insane things I know directly is that this guy named Jim Clapper, the Director of National Intelligence, actually opened an office of outreach within the ODNI. Now, think about this, Alex. The office of the central office of our intelligence community opens an office of outreach to work with them. That's how insane this got. And Mike Flynn, our friend Mike, we've talked about this. Mike has publicly acknowledged that he was ordered to send arms into Syria to help arm the elements which were supposed to be resisting and helping remove President Assad from power. But it turned out that those arms went to Muslim Brotherhood and other elements which were the precursors of ISIS. So again, and Mike did not do this willingly. He did it as he was ordered to do it. So I think if you just simply, Alex, if you simply look at the facts without emotion, there's a very clear leaning and support by our government for an organization which we know to be terrorist-related and declared a terrorist organization by multiple Middle Eastern countries.
And that was the breaking point 4 years ago for our military, as you said, across the board, the Marines, the Army, you name it. And out of that, now we see the overall resistance, the attempt to bring these people into our country. What is the point of bringing 5 million into Europe, hundreds of thousands into the U.S.? Hillary wants a 550% increase. Why would we bring in 80% military-age men from the most unstable places in the world?
Well, two reasons. I mean, she has said publicly, Ms. Clinton has said publicly, she really admires Angela Merkel. Well, what does that tell you? Ms. Merkel is responsible for destabilizing Germany. In a country that did not have the capacity, she brought in a million plus refugees, immigrants. I call them immigrants. This is actually a migration, Alex. Yeah, exactly. And now Germany is destabilized. I mean, it is not the country it was just 3 years ago because of this onslaught. So what does that tell you? If Ms. Clinton is saying, I want to do the same thing as Angela Merkel has done, that's what she intends to do. She's not bluffing. She's not speaking politically.
Sure, so what is the end game of the socialists? They just have such a hatred for the West. They think, hey, it'll be fun. Let's bring in Europe-wide 5 million jihadis.
That's what's going to happen. It does two things. First, it then gives the government more authority to quote unquote do security. Oh my goodness, we are insecure. We have to protect you. So, Alex, it's a version of that disease where you injure your kids, and then you want to be the one who solves them. It's the moonshot
by proxy.
I've done it at the international level. So what happens is you create this underclass who will always vote for you. These people come in, their gratitude is going to be with the party who brings them in, the Democrats. You then, by doing it, you create this permanent underclass, and then at the same time, you're creating chaos to the level that requires government intervention. It requires DHS to expand its powers. It requires the government to call for the federalization of local police forces. It actually does a number of things they seek to do.
Exactly. So the radical Muslim threat is real, but liberal governments are bringing them in as the false flag to then take control of the society. Now, I've been asking the questions. We've only got 5 minutes left. And Colonel Schaefer, you're the real expert on what's happening globally. What is your gut level, and what's the other intel you've got on this election? Trump's ahead in all the battlegrounds, the real polls. They're doing oversampling of 9 to 20 points, on average about 12 for Hillary. I mean, I'm not just saying this is wishful thinking. It looks like a landslide for Trump, even on the Electoral College. Democrats don't like her, but she's still confident. We've got evidence of election fraud coming in. What are your concerns about the election and other points?
There's been study put forth the last couple of days about how there's only been 31 instances of people being caught voting illegally. Alex, that's completely a false premise. If people don't have IDs, how do you verify if there's been fraud or not? It's not possible. The reference group you're going to is not going to voluntarily tell you, yeah, I didn't have an ID and I voted twice. It's not possible to determine this.
There's zero enforcement. The Democrats admit they want illegals to vote.
Exactly. So this is the other issue. So I think there's a great potential for that. My advice to your audience, use paper ballots. Make sure that you have a record, a hard copy record. I've been putting this out to everybody I talk to. Go the old-fashioned way until we can get the system fixed, because there's all sorts of electronic manipulation that can happen. There's been instances I've seen where people push a button and it votes for the candidate. So buyer beware. Secondly, regarding the trend, look, a lot of friends of mine who have followed election trends for a long time see this shaping up just like the Carter Reagan run in 1980. A lot of the same dynamics are now at play, and clearly Carter was seen as an establishment candidate. He was, and there was a big backlash against the establishment candidate, and clearly Trump is a big backlash against the establishment, which is, I think, overdue. So I think if things run the way I think others have predicted them, and I tend to agree with these views, I think we may be seeing 1980 all over again right now.
I agree. In the 4 minutes we've got left, I know you're not trying to pitch your book, but let's go back to it. It came out a few years ago. I read it, where you, because I know you can't put obviously classified stuff in a nonfiction book. I'm not saying you did that with this book, but I tell you, wow, did it come true? How in the world did you write that book? Because 4 years ago, I mean, none of this was even on the radar for me, at least.
Well, there's two things. First, Alex, I saw, as many did, this rising Mexican nationalism, which was attempting to essentially say that, hey, there's no difference between America and Mexico. We should, and by the way, there's this thing called the Zapatistas, this movement to that calls for the return of the southwest border states to Mexico.
Aslan.
I just thought that, right. And so I saw that as a potential weak point within our own thinking, that people aren't thinking this thing through. But I see these migrants coming in, demonstrating that they have no respect for our culture, for our flag. And that was something I just noted as someone who studies trends and threats. So I put that together with some of what we've seen happen regarding this globalist attitude. you know, the certain place that you visited, I watched with great amusement when I wrote the book regarding meetings of the elites and having certain ideas of what they think is best. And you put that together with some of the other things that I know have gone on in other places. We turned it into a work of fiction. But with that said, everything in that book has elements of the truth embedded. It's just we've rearranged it for purposes of both good reading, but also as a warning. So that was why I wrote the book, Alex. I told you at the time, I think you were a bit skeptical, but I said, look, this is supposed to be a warning to the American people that there are things that could happen that they need to be aware of. And that was my interest. You know, I don't have a lot of time to write fiction. As you know, I'm very busy doing real things. So when I write something, I tend to do it for purposes of informing. And frankly, you and I both know the best way to inform sometimes is to entertain.
People I agree. When I say skeptical, you know, a few years ago when we talk about it, it's not that I didn't believe what you were saying was accurate. It's just it's so crazy that the elite run the U.S., and they run Europe. Why do they want to wreck it if they're already in charge? But they fundamentally don't like what it stands for. They want to mount the head on the wall. It's really a very, vandalistic, what do you call it, psychologically?
I think it's something that they didn't create, and therefore they want to destroy for purposes of reestablishing it in their own image. I mean, it's a very ego-driven, very very egocentric, dare I say, narcissistic point of view. This is why you see President Obama apologizing for the good America's done over the past 200 years. That's why you see Ms. Clinton saying that, hey, we're doing okay being number two. Really? Well, let me tell you something. You know, as much as you and I agree, I don't believe in aggressive war. There are things we stand for as a nation, which is the gold standard.
Plus, they're the ones launching all the illegal wars that aren't right. They're the ones. Here's the deal. America's got a lot of problems, but you look at the history, we have been exceptional because of the liberty and freedom. We need to expand that. And so they sit, and then they're the ones that are the worst managers ever. And then they blame America for what they've done. It's incredible.
Right. Absolutely. That's the point, is that they have gone out to do everything they can to diminish our role, our leadership, and frankly, being a guidepost or beacon of how to live. My close friend Bruce Fine has talked about how we should be an example we wish to help people emulate, not an example we wish to inflict on others. And this is where we differ with Hillary and the neocons, some of the other folks. They wish to go in and invade and somehow believe, you know, going into Libya, removing Gaddafi you're going to see democracy spring forth. It's not possible. Any culture has to.
Plus, you can't make a deal with him, have him come in out of the dark, democratize, and then kill him. That the dishonor is making the deal and setting him up. If you want to knock him out, do it. Don't make a deal and stab him in the back.
And that's exactly what happened. So this is one of those things, Alex, I think we would agree upon. We as the Americans have a great society based on the fact that we have, as you said, what makes us exceptional is the fact we have individual liberty. We have the ability to think for ourselves. And I think that's what we should be seeking, to help others seek that for themselves and encouraging it. We cannot
give
it to them.
That's right. We're out of time. Thank you for the time. Tony-Schaefer.com. Find all his books online, Twitter, Facebook, and more. Thank you so much. We really appreciate you.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
We'll find out about the election soon and talk to you after that. We'll be back with the latest election news straight ahead. Powerful interview. I'm Alex Jones. Stay with us. We got a lot coming up today, ladies and gentlemen. A lot to cover, a lot to break down. You know, I can just tell you this right now. Again, our military's done a lot of evil stuff. The government's done bad things, but that's what governments do. We're not defending it. But the military is so awake, it is crazy. It is absolutely crazy. I was talking to some of the UFC fighters that met with Trump out in Albuquerque when he came out there, gave a speech, and was hanging out with some of the folks that were doing the pre-fight stuff with Tim Kennedy. And some of the former UFC champions, people were out there. And it's just all InfoWars. We had a crew member reporter out there. We've got all this footage. And we've got Shane Steiner fighting the former world champion heavyweight female. That's on video. That's like super viral. They didn't let anybody get her on tape. She let us have this footage. We've got so much stuff. It'll make your head spin. You say, oh, why do we care about that? Because we get into the sports world and we wake up all the folks that are there who wouldn't be tuned into what's happening. It's not the sports are bad. You just can't make that the final thing that your whole life's about. But we jacked into the matrix to get people that are in sports and wake them up on liberty issues. That's why somebody like a Tim Kennedy, you know, is going for the championship, is because then he can reach out to people with the message of liberty. That's why you do this, is because in this modern Rome, that's how you actually get to people. Now, I've got a bunch of stuff I want to get to, but Kit Daniels just ran here with a new article. Cataclysm 2016, Cubs win, Brexit point to Trump victory. And I've been trying to think of the Cubs, who haven't been to the World Series in forever. I don't claim to know the factoids on this, but I know this is the hottest thing right now, is the Cubs and the election. And I'm trying to think of an angle to hijack this, because I've done this before and like had, you know, videos with 5 million, 10 million views when I hijack a sports thing. So I wanted to ask the whole crew. I was asking Rob Dew last night. He came over for dinner with his kids, both my kids, his wife. How do I hijack the Cubs? Because I don't know, for the New York Times says I'm going to physically do it. I mean, how do I hijack the Cubs? Are they in their final game tonight or something? I haven't even followed it. What is it? Is it over? Is it still going? I mean, oh, they won the World Series. See, I don't even know this. My son's like, Dad, please turn on the World Series. And I said, no, we're not turning the TV on because that's, you know, I mean, in fact, I'm proud of the fact that I didn't know this. See, people say, oh, my God, this guy's an idiot. He doesn't know the Cubs just won the World Series. I know Bill Murray went to the White House 2 weeks ago and was talking about them going to the World Series. I mean, I'm sorry. I'm concerned about globalists that want my guns. Now, I'll be honest. Tommy Pilato, the movie producer, used to live in Austin. And back when the Red Sox went again, because I like baseball. I played baseball in middle school and high school. But I'm either in it or I'm not. I did watch the World Series, and I almost bought tickets to go see it. So, see, I kind of like, I've either got to totally turn it off or I've got to totally get into it. I mean, does that make sense, Matt?
Totally makes sense.
All right, so I sound like a big idiot here. Cataclysm 2016, Cubs win. But the Cubs, they say, are unlucky and never win. That kind of is like a major omen that Trump's going to win. I agree with that statement. What do you say?
I wouldn't necessarily link the Cubs win to Donald Trump. But yeah, you know, 2016 has been a really interesting year. I thought about it last night. You know, we've got...
But it is kind of quirky, like underdog, you know?
Oh, yeah. It's just been a roller coaster year. We've got... this wild election, we've got, you know, Prince, Merle Haggard, they passed away.
There's no need to fear. Underdog is here. Sorry.
It's just, 2016 is just breaking the mold. Everything that was old, everything that
was... That's it. 2016, because, I mean, I'm not even a modern baseball fan. By that, I mean, I followed when I was a teenager in college and just had to stop because I'm doing this. But, like I said, you know, you can only date one woman. But yeah, the Cubs were like the most unlucky team ever, couldn't win. It was impossible. There was a curse, right?
I don't know if it's...
Well, it was a curse on the Red Sox, too.
Curse, but in one form or another, I guess it was more infamous with the Red Sox, from what I know. But yeah, people have lived and died without seeing the Cubs win. So that is... It's a pretty big day for them. Pretty big day for...
I think it's a great sign people, the Cubs came back. I got to tell you. I mean, you know...
What's up?
I mean, I do think it's a good sign for Trump. I mean, that's what Kit Daniels is saying. Cataclysm 2016, Cubs win, Brexit points to Trump victory. Political outsider Donald Trump could easily win the presidential candidate 2016 in a year of cataclysmic change, which is what Kit's saying, what you just said. It breaks the mold. In human history, with the Chicago Cubs winning their first World Series in 108 years and British voters rejecting their vassalage to the EU. I think that says it all, brother.
Yeah, you know, the stars
are the Cubs winning the final nail in Hillary Clinton.
I'm sorry?
Is this the final nail with the Chicago Cubs, where she's from? She's really a crime boss. Is that not a sign here that this, I mean, I think it's a sign, actually.
You know, if the Cubs can win, so can Donald Trump. How about that? How about that? That's a pretty powerful statement, right?
But I mean, I gotta really tell you, it is weird that they've never won. And then I thought they had another game. I haven't been paying attention. And I knew they were close, but I was freaking out yesterday. No wonder my dad and son were at my house. We're like, Dad, turn on the TV, the World Series. And I'm like, no, no, no. So there you go. It shows how is that shameful that I wasn't aware of this?
You're not a great American, actually.
I was too busy with Rob Dew shooting a video about how we've discovered the big company that does all the big graphics for the networks preparing a Hillary win, even in Texas. You know about that?
Oh, I know all about that. You know, I figured they've probably got the whole thing, you know, pre-built. You know what I mean? They've probably had some of those graphics built a while ago.
Well, you're right. It turns out it was a couple months ago. Drudge's linked to our story, at least last time I checked. And again, we're not saying this is proof of rigging. But Google's been rigged. The polls have been rigged. Everything else has been rigged. I mean, my God, it's the era of rigging coming. It's the era of rigging being exposed.
Can you imagine being in one of those liberal workplaces where it's like this dictatorship, and you go to give a presentation and you give something that's got a pro-Trump slant? You'd probably be out of there faster than your head can spin.
Absolutely. Well, here it is. Since people bring it up, I've got the articles right here. Let me get your take on this. NBC caught preparing, and I said this, but then I noticed it was all the networks. But NBC, it's actually all of them. NBC caught preparing Hillary victory results before election. Alex Jones, InfoWars, there's a war on for your mind. And it goes on. An NBC station was caught posting election results showing a Hillary Clinton victory. It's actually nationwide. But again, we just singled out this one. Feeling concerns that mainstream media is conditioning the public to accept a rigged election favoring Hillary. Political activists discovered a hidden website for WRCB out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, where they're getting it nationally, showing election results that Hillary Clinton securing a 3-4-3 election vote, 40% of the popular vote. The website originated from FTP server World Now, a media software company that provides real-time data such as electronic results, election results, and other media assets to local news stations. And you go through it, as I said, it's nationwide. That was just the one we focused in on because that was an earlier investigation, 5 p.m., by like 9 at night, we were in it, thousands of pages. They have her winning Texas by 2 points. They have her winning the nation by 1 million popular votes. And then narrowly winning because she wins Texas, which I've been saying they're acting like they're going to win. What do you make of them getting graphics ready beforehand?
Well, I think the other day you did use this statement when you said that they were sowing, they're reaping what they sowed, and that in the sowing phase, you know, they were putting out these polls that, again, did oversample Democrats. And to that point, you know, how far they oversampled them, what you can take away from those numbers is that, you know, they're saying that people are more fired up for Hillary Clinton than they were for Barack Obama, which I think is contrary to what we see on the ground, especially at these rallies. So you got that going for you. B, she's not the change candidate. I think there are a number of other factors that are more insightful as to, you know, what people are actually paying attention to. And one of those, you know, Michael Snyder was on the show about a week ago, and, you know, he had an article from a while back talking about how stock markets typically can be a good indicator of who's going to win a presidential election. You've got, you know, all these Google trends where you see people are, you know, searching out the wazoo for these Hillary Clinton email scandals, the Podesta, the WikiLeaks.
Yeah, you've got something like 15 to 20, depending on the day, on Google. More searches for Trump.
Oh, yeah. When it was normalized at 1, right, the normalization being 1, it was only 4% of that was Donald Trump searches for the sex tape, which I think was kind of, they thought it was the nail in the coffin to Donald Trump. But I think they grossly underestimated people's ability to kind of see.
People aren't idiots. You got a bunch of creeps over 30 years on Hollywood sets trying to record Trump. I've been at so many dinners with media, and they're asking me weird questions, and I go, wait a minute, let me look for a recorder. And they'll have a phone recording on the table or one in their pocket. And I go, are you recording this? Oh, yeah, is that okay? I'm like, yeah, but you're asking me weird questions of stuff I didn't bring up. And I've had people record me, edit it, send me the edited tape, and go, you want to talk about this, like blackmail? And I go, release it. You've edited that. Go to hell. I don't care.
Oh, and when we talk about blackmail, it is the pot calling the kettle black in Clinton's case, because she, you know, people are saying, you know, Jill Stein was in the media saying that Hillary is, you know, the worst person ever or whatever. And then she came back and said, you know, Trump is this walking scandal, and that's what everyone wants you to believe. But the problem with that is that when you want to talk about blackmailable, let's talk about Huma carrying that 650,000 set of emails, you know what I mean, that could easily blackmail Hillary Clinton. You know, when I start to think like a criminal, like one of those criminals in the Democratic Party, you know, it's tough to give her a pass on that any other way. What other reason would you have for keeping all those emails if you weren't going to sell them yourself?
650,000 emails. No, they admit that's why the FBI began this. It's an espionage investigation.
Oh, yeah. Either she was selling them herself or she was planning to use them as blackmail. And if you think about all these people, what if she gave all that information to the people who are giving vast sums of money to Hillary Clinton's campaign, like Qatar and Saudi Arabia, right? She's feeding them all this information. They're like, okay, let's get this woman in.
And that's why the communist They're Chinese so and every money. Other, the Muslims, they all want her in because it's she's a nice compromised. She's a horrible demon they put in. It's a big joke on us. It's not that our agencies are perfect or our government's perfect. This is such a bad deal. Finally, our government's forced to fight it because it's suicide. This is insane to put a sick person mentally but also physically in who's totally compromised is insane, is a clear and present danger. We're only 4 days, 3.5 days out, Matt. What do you predict?
Well, you know, at this point, I wouldn't put it's tough to make a definite
She's a cornered rat,
prediction.
Even though it'll blow up in her face.
It is.
And will she go all the way?
I've heard a lot of other pundits that talk about, you know, what she must have. She's got to empty it all now. You know, whatever she's got.
Well, and she doesn't have stuff on Trump. This is key what you said. She has dirt on everybody else.
Oh,
and yeah. That's the real power that Hillary has right now is her dirt. But at a certain point, okay, release your dirt. We're going to release what you and Wiener are up to. Thank you, Matt.
Yeah, no problem.
Great point. Matt's a smart guy. We love getting him on the show. I encourage the rest of the crew to pop him, too. Because, I mean, they're just really smart folks. They always make great points. A lot of what you hear on air is points they make to me. Before I go any further, because we've got Anthony Acumia coming up to host the fourth hour. Nightly News tonight, 7 o'clock Central. We have sponsors that make this all possible. About 30% of our funding is sponsors. And I'm trying to bring more sponsors in because we want to be multifaceted here. Solutions from Science has an amazing solar generator that's expandable. You can hook wind turbine into it. With all the war talk and the rest of it, you need to be self-sufficient. Solutions from Science is having a moving warehouse sale. Here are three reasons you should get one of their perfect power solar generators. It's the same one I have in my home, the top-of-the-line model. It's expandable. It has a wind input, even processes pure sine wave power, so you can run medical equipment, even military-grade electronics. Go to PowerGridChaos.com. That's PowerGridChaos.com. Save 70% while supplies last. PowerGridChaos.com. And continuing, Revelations, the Dawn of Global Government film is now out, and it's extremely powerful. With myself, Charlie Daniels, General Boykin, current founder of Special Forces in the modern era, folks that never show their head in public. I mean, they're in this film. We've got Joel Skousen and so many others. Who else is in it? A bunch of people. You've got, like, Gerald Celente. Covers all the big topics of privacy, Agenda 21, Federal Reserve, New World Order, globalism. Visit revelationthemovie.info to purchase the DVD or check it out. Hosting it in your area or a theater in your area at revelationthemovie.info. But get the DVD, revelationthemovie.info. Great patriots. And finally, we are extending right now a 42-hour sale, but it's going to end tomorrow. 30 to 40% off on high-quality storable foods at InfoWarsStore.com. This is My Patriot Supply, their latest packaged food, drop shipped by them, private labeled as InfoWars Select, their full category, their full catalog, 34% off. After we took down our 34% off storable food special last night, listeners began calling and asking us to extend the special. We are able to get on the phone with the manufacturer and extend the special for an additional 42 hours. That started yesterday. With Hillary and the globalist allies trying to steal the election, there has never been a better and more crucial time to get started preparing for the future with storable food. All InfoWars Select foods have a shelf life of 25 years and are made with super high quality ingredients made in the USA. There's a reason FEMA report predicts a 395% increase in food prices that could trigger mass unrest. We don't know what's coming, but we could and should have started getting prepared today. 34% off all InfoWars Select horrible foods at InfoWarsStore.com in the next 42 hours only. A lot of special diets, you name it, it's all there. Really amazing folks, InfoWarsStore.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And what's beautiful about this operation is you're making it all possible. You're funding it. You're getting products you need, insurance you can eat, high-quality supplements, pro-gun T-shirts, non-GMO heirloom seeds that produce seeds each year. This is all about a win-win. It's all about creating prosperity. It's all about funding independent true media that won't back down, that won't give in, and that is committed to standing up for this republic. Now, I've got other stories I want to hit from CNN and others, demonizing alternative media that is the new media. When we come back, then we'll hand the baton to Anthony Cumia, joining us from New York. October gun sales see massive spike. Yet another victory against the globalists as all-time records are broken. The people understand the attempt is to domesticate us. They're becoming independent, and I salute you all. Less than 4 days out now. All right, syndicated radio host Anthony Cumia works with the great Gavin McGinnis and others. He'll be taking over in the next hour. I've seen a trend the last few weeks on CNN.com where they warn us about fake news, like sampling 45% or more Democrats than Republicans to give Hillary a 68% victory. I noticed when I went to CNN.com this morning, they had Hillary winning by 2 points. They weren't having her win by 25 points or more because they know that it's going to be very close if they even steal it, and that Trump's really way ahead. But they think you're dumb. They don't think you remember that last week she was 20-something points ahead. You know, Trump's down in 30-something. She's up at 60-something. They think you're a moron. But they're going to tell you about fake news. And so many times there are fake news sites out there. We track back to governments and corporations, and they'll mix our info into it to make us sound like idiots. It's got to be Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com if my name's on it or me talking about it. Or it's not us, folks. So if they can't counter us, they just put out this info. I saw stories out this week going, Alex Jones has found a group worse than the Nazis and the Soviets. It's the National Guard. The National Guard, he believes, wants to kill you and your family. The National Guard are great people, some of the best folks out there. I said that operations where they do domestic training are to condition the military and the police for domestic control. That's what these different programs were. But they lie and misrepresent. And I know you, the audience, get that. They're targeting people that are looking for the truth. But here it is. Oh, CNN that cares so much about us. The plague of fake news is getting worse. Here's how to protect yourself. Oh, thank you, CNN, for protecting us from the fake news. You are so good. That's Brian Stetler telling us how to do it. And it goes on how Trump's making up that there's a criminal investigation into Hillary. It's really not criminal, they say. So there you go. Thank God they're exposing Trump. He's fake. He's lying to us. Here's another one. Five stunning fake news stories that reach millions. They'll mix fake stories in with real stories to confuse people. Again, that's the new talking point. That's from CNN Money. Here's another one. Fraudulent ICOA press releases. Fake news is always fake news. Snopes, that's like not against her that she's fat, but a fat lady with a cat that Soros funds. She tells you what's real. Snopes, oh. It's like if I get up in the morning and, you know, eat eggs. Do I ask Snopes if I eat eggs or not? Thank God Snopes is there, though. Thank our little lucky stars. Of course, I couldn't say they're stars. Gotta ask Snopes, what are those in the night sky? Are those distant suns? Snopes is like, no, those are holes poked in a blanket. Yeah, Google Truth Police to be run by a cat lady. That's an article. Snopes.com run by a cat lady and her husband. Nothing against cat ladies, folks. It's just, I got a cat. One of my daughters likes cats. We got two cats. Kind of like them, kind of don't. Like they walk by and knock something off for no reason. You're like, you just broke two things today, you little creature. Now you're on top of me at midnight with your feet in my chest, like making biscuits, making tortillas. I'll be asleep. All of a sudden, cat goes, pow, hits me the side of the head. I'm like, why not deserve that? But Snopes says if a cat hits you in the face for no reason, did it make a sound unless Snopes admitted it did? And that's the most important point. Snopes has the answers. You go to the mountain, and then Snopes gives you the answers down in CNN. They tell you about the fake news. Thank goodness I know about fake news now from the MSM. Totally discredited, totally collapsing. Back in 70 seconds with Anthony Cumia. Stay with us. Nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock Central. Special reports, Infowars.com. It's Anthony Cumia from our East Coast studios. Here he is, folks.
Thank you, Alex. Very happy to be here once again for Infowars.com. Anthony Cumia here. Well, like Alex just said, 4 days. Is that where we are? 4 days? What are we going to do after this is over? This has become a part of our lives. It's like you got a pet. If you have a pet for a year and a half, you're pretty attached to that thing. You are pretty attached to the dog or cat or whatever you had for a year and a half. And then it's just going to be gone. And, you know, we'll have to live with the consequences. Like, so let's say it's like a pet that made mess all over your floor. And now the pet's gone, but you're left with the consequences of the pet. Just enough to let you remember what it was all about. But we got 4 days left. And then we'll know who the next president is going to be after the inauguration in January. And they'll talk about it on the press, but it's not going to be anything like we've been through for the past year and a half, because it won't matter anymore who said this and who said that. And if it's Hillary, we'll have the fun of watching her go through her various scandals and FBI investigations. That'll be a little bit of fun. And mark my words on this one, too. I hope the opportunity for me to be right does not happen, because it hinges on a Hillary presidency, which I absolutely don't want to see. I want to see Donald Trump win this thing. But here's what I'm thinking as I drop my pen. Here's what I'm thinking. Let's say Hillary does win the election. I know. I'm sorry. She goes through these FBI investigations. The press is not going to be nice to her. You know how they're all in her corner right now? They're all trying their hardest to get Hillary Clinton elected. That will go away in 4 days. I swear to you, if she gets elected, that will go away. Because one thing the press is more so than liberal bias, which they have, oh my God, shown over the past year and a half, is greedy. Oh, are they greedy? And they have zero loyalty. It's not like they're loyal. They have their reasons for wanting Hillary Clinton to be the president. It's their liberal bias. They have a reason for that. And most of it does hinge on some kind of greed that they have. But if Hillary gets elected, they're not going to cover up any of these stories anymore. You will see. And by the way, now that I think about it, maybe even after Trump gets elected, you're still going to see the media completely spin on Hillary, because they know it's a juicy story and they can't leave a juicy story alone, can they? They will jump on her. President or not, that's what I'm saying. There, now it's better, because it doesn't hinge on a Hillary presidency. President or not, they will turn on Hillary in a second, because it makes for a great headline. And they will start digging and uncovering, and you'll see all the stuff that we should have seen for a year and a half. We'll see it all happen in 4 days. and that's what we're gunning for. Just amazing. The media not stopping their steamroller over Trump and Trump supporters. You see it every day. Every day, turn on that mainstream media. And first of all, you won't see this Donna Brazile. You won't see her. She got fired from CNN because, as you probably heard, she got questions for the town hall and one of the debates against Bernie Sanders that Hillary was having from Roland Martin over there, and decided to give it to Hillary. And it wasn't even like, well, she didn't use it or this. Extended 42 hours, save 30 to 40% on InfoWars select storable food after we took down our 30 to 40% off storable food special last night. Listeners began calling and asking us to extend the special. We were able to get on the phone with the manufacturer and extend the special for an additional 42 hours only. With Hillary and her globalist allies trying to steal the election, there's never been a more crucial time to start preparing for the future with storable food. All InfoWars Select foods have a shelf life of 25 years and are made with super high quality ingredients in the USA. There's a reason that FEMA reports predict up to 395% increase in food prices that could trigger mass unrest. You don't know what's happening in the world these days. It's nuts. We don't know what's coming, but you could start getting ready for whatever may happen today. Get 30 to 40% off all InfoWars Select storable food at InfoWarsStore.com for the next 42 hours only. Caught me picking, did you? I was scratching. How you doing? Anthony Cumia back for InfoWars.com. I was talking about Donna Brazile, that whole scandal that we've just barely seen on any mainstream media. Giving questions to Hillary Clinton for the debates where Bernie Sanders was just thrown to the wolves. It's nice to see him getting so upset about it and talking about it and not criticizing Hillary, maybe picking another candidate to support. Oh, that's right. He hasn't. Just another shill. Just another Hillary shill promoting her, going around the country. He was directly screwed over by Hillary, the DNC, Donna Brazile, Wassermer. Before Brazil, they all just do what they want. They do what they want, like there's no rules or laws that apply to them, and they do it to reach their end, which is Hillary Clinton as president of the United States. Wow, that's a hard one to say. That is a hard one to stomach. Roland Martin gave her the questions. Now, Brazile was fired by CNN. She was a paid contributor. She'd be on there and talk about the election and whatnot, which is sort of odd, I think, in the first place. How is the interim head, and by the way, she's the interim head of the DNC because, remember, the first one was fired for more cheating and scandals. So she's the interim head of the DNC, and she's a paid contributor to one of the news stations. Do they even try anymore to separate so there's no conflicts of interest like that? Do they even try? No, they obviously don't. The head of the DNC, a paid employee of one of the major news outlets, that, sorry, call me crazy, bothers me a little. I see a bit of a conflict of interest there. And Roland Martin is the one that gave her the question. Gave it to her. Well, buddy, they're working at the same place. Why hasn't Roland Martin been fired? If CNN fired her because they just are the bastion of journalism, aren't they? Of ethical journalism, CNN? So why not fire Roland Martin? He was responsible, too. He gave her the questions. But no, we can't do that. So they go on and on just lying to us. Has anyone seen Huma? Just such a close friend of Hillary Clinton's. Actually, Hillary once called her a second daughter. Right up until all those emails poured out of her and her husband's computers. Then she was called a staffer, I think. Was it a staffer? There's just no pride with these people. So Huma is part of now the newest scandal that's going on that the media is trying so hard to not acknowledge and not address. There was the investigation going on with Anthony Weiner, who is now, oh, let's all give him our thoughts and prayers. He's now in a sex rehab, just trying to get better. Here's the deal, I believe, with sex rehabilitation. I don't see it working, especially for someone like Anthony Weiner. This guy knew, he knew that this was destroying his life, everything in it, his career, his marriage, his political aspirations. He knew it. And time again, there he was, getting in trouble again, because this guy can't stop. He just can't stop. He is a degenerate and cannot stop. Rehab will do nothing. It's just a thing to put on your apology resume and make things try to make things go away. But this isn't going away. So the FBI is investigating him, sending sexually explicit messages to a 15-year-old girl. And lo and behold, there's these emails, more emails, because any correspondence between Hillary and Huma, and Huma's collecting correspondence from Hillary. And we don't know what it is yet. But I tell you, when Comey, FBI Director Comey, came out and announced that there was indeed an investigation, that they were going to continue looking into Hillary Clinton's emails, looking for some type of problem there, you knew that it was something big. I don't know. It's obvious Comey wasn't playing partisan politics when he came out and said, well, we recommended that no charges be filed against Hillary Clinton to the Justice Department back in July. You might remember that. And then all of a sudden, he comes out with this. I believe he's covering his own butt here. I honestly believe that there's too much there. And now it's been spread out with Huma and Anthony Weiner. There's no protecting that. Once the cat's out of the bag to that extent, then you have to pursue it. And I think in order to cover his own butt, that's what FBI Director Comey did. Came out and said, yes, there is an issue, and we are looking into it. Again, what it is, we can only imagine at this point. And Hillary and the Democrats are doing their best to try to get this out of the news cycle, trying everything. I saw something the other day on, I believe it was, again, CNN. They brought up something from literally 2 years ago. They were trying to get some kind of traction going. They bring out this completely non-credible lawsuit that's going on or trying to get some traction with Donald Trump. Some 13-year-old girl years ago was alleging that there was some sexual assault that went on between Donald Trump and her. There were no criminal charges ever filed. Still aren't. Can't be. But there's a lawsuit, some kind of a civil case going on. And apparently she had this civil case years ago, canceled it, and now lo and behold, again, Donald Trump running for president. Well, let's bring this out. Let's bring this up again after years and years and years. Two witnesses all of a sudden are there. It's so obvious. If something stinks, it's because it's bad. And everything they try to grab against Trump, the media, and the Democrats, everything they try to bring up just reeks. It reeks because there's no evidence to it. And it comes up right before he's running for president. All those years, 40 years in the public eye in New York. Builder, entertainer, nothing. Now he's the worst businessman ever. He screws over every builder he's ever worked with. Sex, he's grabbing women by areas. It's just insane. And anyone who doesn't see this, I think, has problems. They have problems. How could you not? People's eyes are not open. They are so connected with Hillary Clinton emotionally. Emotionally. Saw the woman just the other day on the news crying The daughter asked her, "Mom, why are you crying?" She's like, I got to vote for a woman for president. Her only reason. Her only reason for voting for Hillary. She's a woman. They share anatomy. They share an anatomy. Could you imagine if that's the qualifier? If you went to the polls and thought, well, he's got two ears, I'll pull the lever for the two-eared guy. And that's what women seem to be doing when they hop on this Hillary bandwagon for no other reason than to say, look at what we did. We elected one of our own. And then they talk about how we shouldn't separate and segregate and do anything. One of our own. It's a woman. It's a woman. Hey, equality. It goes on and on like this. I'm often astounded by it, but never surprised. Never surprised. We'll be right back with more InfoWars. I'm Anthony Cumia. Stick around. Hello, everybody. Anthony Cumia for InfoWars.com. Wonderful Alex Jones. Talking about the election, obviously. Huge. This is huge. 4 days left. And you got to start wondering, what might this country look like in a couple of years after the president gets in there and gets up to speed? I talk to a lot of people, and they say, a large majority of people say, the president, they don't do anything. They don't really, they're a figurehead. Yeah, but there's a lot of checks and balances in place. But there is something the president does. It's a mood that the country has. The president can set a mood for the country. We saw this in blazing detail after Jimmy Carter left office and Ronald Reagan came in. We were beaten as a country. Looked like garbage in the world's eyes. Reagan came in. And without any specific plan or legislation or anything, the country felt better about itself. It started working together, being proud to be American again after all those Carter years where it just seemed like nothing worked. There wasn't any pride in this country. And I think a lot of people feel the same way now. After 8 years of Obama, that's the type of thing a president can do, set a tone and a mood for the country. What we looked at before, if you recall the 8 years before Obama, do you recall the police being as despised as they are? Do you recall racial tensions being at the level that they're at now? And the world's view of the United States being so low to where Russia is literally laughing at us and flying over our ships with their planes as a goof. That's the type of thing a president can do. I honestly think that we need that boost back again. We need somebody in office that will make us proud to be American again. And a lot of people see that as, oh, gee, look at you, America, America. It's important. The people that don't see that are the people that have no sense of nation. They don't want borders. They want them all open, like Hillary said. Like Hillary said when she's talking to Wall Street, open borders. That's the problem. We need a president that has a sense of nation. That's a bad word now. You say that you love America. You want America to be respected. You want people to feel like they want to be Americans. And you're the idiot. You're the one that's making the problem. And you're probably a Nazi. They love that word, too. You're probably a Nazi. But that's, we need to appreciate that we're Americans. That seemed to go away with a lot of people, especially on the left. Oh, my God. And immigrants, if I can even, I don't even know what an immigrant is anymore. You talk to left, it's anybody that decided to trot on in to the United States of America. is an immigrant, undocumented immigrant. When people are just allowed to roll over the border into this country, you're not going to see the type of immigrant that wants to become American. You will see whatever country they're from. If they're Mexican, then it's Mexican people living in America as Mexicans. There's no real sense or need to become American. Syrian refugees, Somali refugees, I don't see much assimilation going on there either. A lot of people from these countries collect in one spot and don't assimilate and segregate themselves. They have their own local government, their own businesses, and America is not even in their mindset. They have no want or need to become Americans. This just needs to change. There is a benefit, and it's an asset to us to have the population of this country identify as Americans. And how that became a bad thing over the 8 years that Obama's been in office, that's how a president can have an influence on the mood of a country. And I would like to see that change. We'll be back in moments. Don't go anywhere. Infowars.com. Yes. And in for Alex for his last hour of the show, me, Anthony Cumia, on Infowars.com. There is a huge, huge collection of disillusioned people. And that's the whole Trump thing. That's what made Trump a viable candidate, why he swept through the primaries, and why I believe he will win the election. I can't say for sure. This is one of those situations where the polls, I don't even understand the polls anymore, and I'm not ashamed to say that. I look at a lot of news every day from a lot of different sources, and I pop those polls up, and I look, and then some other polls, and I'll see it on mainstream media, on alternative media. I'll look. Nothing jibes. There doesn't seem to be a trend for anything based on different sources. Now, I'm not one to trust CNN's polling or NBC's polling or anything like that. And theirs doesn't even jibe together. And they're both in Hillary's pockets. And then alternative media, you'll see Trump's ahead. And then I'll hear, wow, Trump is really gaining steam in some of the swing states. And then, oh boy, Hillary's way ahead in the swing state. So we're being bamboozled. It's not hard to see. Again, open your eyes wide enough. Try to shake whatever ideology you've had in your head for so long and really look. Why do you think there would be so many different results for polls? It's to confuse us. We must be kept confused. We mustn't really know who's ahead or who's behind, who has the best chance of winning, who doesn't. We can't be trusted with that kind of information, people. Oh, my God. Because when the results come out, we aren't allowed to have something that says, hey, but this said that it was supposed to go the other way. So if they throw everything at us, whatever the result is, there'll be some type of proof that that it was on the up and up. I cannot even believe I'm saying stuff like this, because years ago, I'd watch Alex here on InfoWars and go, my God, what is this man talking about? This is a little off the rails. But if you open your eyes and really try to look and see what the motivation is, it starts making complete sense. How about this? How about the fact that we have not seen one ISIS terrorist event in a Western nation? We have not seen any Black Lives Matter protests. Where did they go? Did the world all of a sudden get better? Is the world a better place? Is that not a problem anymore? Or are there absolutely people and groups that orchestrate this stuff? Again, open the eyes, take a look around. I understand people will watch or listen to this and think, wow, Anthony's lost his mind. He's ready. They call it the tinfoil hat group. But if you really look into it, why? Why haven't there been these protests? You know why? They don't bode well for Hillary Clinton and the Democrats. A terrorist event will not bode well for the Democrats. Black Lives Matter being out on the street protesting doesn't bode well for the Democrats or Hillary Clinton. It makes the country look lawless. When ISIS attacks someone, it makes us look like we're not secure, like someone's not doing their job. And that's why they stopped. Now you think, how could that happen? If people could just stop it, why don't they stop it all the time? They don't want it stopped all the time. They don't want it stopped all the time. These are things that need to keep happening. It's all about control. It's all about control. After a president's in office and there's terrorist events, now you can enact a bunch of different rules and laws that will protect you. Politicians never take rights away from you. They don't do that. They protect you. And the byproduct might be we might have to have a few of our liberties taken away. But isn't it great that you're safe? That's how it works. That's how it's always worked. But if you don't think that people, well, look at some of the Trump protests that have happened at his rallies. All of a sudden, after it came out in the WikiLeaks, one of the WikiLeaks dumps, that those protests were orchestrated by people connected to the DNC and Hillary Clinton, and the cat was out of the bag, as they say, those stopped. They just stopped happening. You don't see it. You watch a Donald speech, Trump at a rally. Watch one today. He's doing 1,000 of them a day, I believe. But you won't have to see him stand there going, oh, okay, get him out. All right, I'll wait. All right, here's another one. Yeah, I'll go. That stopped happening? Did all of a sudden everyone that didn't like Trump just decide to give up? No. They are told and instructed how to carry out these random, spontaneous protests, whether it's at a Trump rally or in the streets with Black Lives Matter. It's all orchestrated. All orchestrated. By whom? Well, there's the rub, isn't it? Who's responsible for all this? I know, listening to InfoWars and Alex, globalists, these people that want this global economy and community and everything, no American exceptionalism, could be. I tend to think it's everyone that is in bed with Hillary Clinton at this point. I don't really see Trump and his people that are in charge having the ability to do those things, having the ability to muster up protesters to send to a Clinton rally or muster up a street protest. It just doesn't seem to happen that way. But for some reason, again, they all just decided to stop. We have 4 days left. And again, trying to figure out what this country might look like. Talked about Trump being in there. I think it'll bring back American pride and the ability to create again in this country. A Hillary Clinton presidency within a couple of years. Again, the disillusioned people in this country are the people that have worked, raised a family, contributed to this country. Not contributed like a charity case. That isn't what it's all about. not opening up your wallet and throwing money out there to needy people. I'm talking about contributing through working, setting up businesses and industry in this country again, making it a great country in the world that can trade on equal footing with other nations and become an industry leader again. That's gone. When you hear Trump say, make America great again, you'll hear the left answer to that by saying, oh, what? Racism? Segregation? Separate water fountains? No. An industry leader, someone that could do trade in the world and actually make money doing it, would be a great thing. That would be making America great again. And that's the type of stuff I think Trump is pitching. I don't think he's pitching bringing us back to any of the dark ages of this country. But again, if you listen to Hillary's speeches, Trump's people who are negative, dark, divisive and dangerous. This is what they have now. Trying to present Trump and the people that support him and will be voting for him as monsters who want to bring America back to all of its evils and terrible deeds that America's done over the years. Not thinking about when America was great and we were a leader in industry. We made things. We were innovative, eager to be proud. Remember the space program, how proud we were of things like that? Achievements as a nation? Where's that? That's when America was great. So when Hillary yells, we're already great, in that voice, she's missing the point. She's either, well, I think she's lying, because anything, you could always excuse Hillary. It's always lying, by the way. It's not she's stupid or she didn't see this. She's lying. That's what the bottom line is with Hillary. But she's lying about America is still great. It is great, but America has a lot more great potential than it is great. And years ago, when we were a leader in the world, was when America was great. I think throughout history, no matter what year it is, you'll always be able to find some dastardly deeds that any country has done that they might not be too proud of. Again, you can't take history out of context. Some things that happened many, many years ago were commonplace and a business as usual, as they say. Looked at with our today's ethics and morality, it looks very bad. But back then, unless you were living in that time, you can't judge. I think as a nation, we've always tried to correct those things and essentially be good, be a good group of people, Americans here in America. But when you say make America great again, they always bring up horrible instances of America's history and say that that's what Trump and his supporters are striving for, to make America that again. And it's just, it's such a weak, phony argument. That isn't what it's all about. Because I don't think half the country's voters, which it is, by the way, it's half the country's vote. Whoever's voting, half of them want Trump at this point, half want Hillary. Who gets it? I have no idea. But you're calling half the country racist, homophobic, misogynistic. Why the hell would you want to live in a country that's half of the people are that awful? But that's how the liberals want to present it. And it's not. When you hear Make America Great Again, I'm not thinking about the Klan riding in with their white hoods. I'm thinking about factories with a lot of workers in them, pumping out products that will go overseas and bring money back to this country. It's just an amazing part of American history, how constructive and innovative and successful we were as a country before, I don't know what, emotion kicked in, before symbolism became more important than substance in this country. before the people that were doing all of the heavy lifting became the enemy in this country? It's the bad guy. The dad and the mom raising a family, going to work every day, paying their taxes, keeping their lawn nice. That is the bad guy. That's the enemy now. It's not diverse enough. It doesn't reflect some of the alternative lifestyles that we have in this country. That's all well and fine, but can we just get back to basics? We've gone so far off the rails in this country that things that are just not that important are now paramount. And things that are very important have either taken a back seat or been designated evil in this country. And, you know, when you hear people knock that motto, and it is a little hard. Look, I'll be honest. It is a little hard for a year and a half to hear a motto or a credo or a slogan. Let's make America great again. Arr! You know, I've never been one for the rah-rah kind of thing. But when there's honesty behind it and you can actually understand what it means, it takes on a new meaning. And I think many Americans know what that does mean. And they can counter when you hear Hillary Clinton yelling. She was literally yelling about how negative and dark and awful Trump supporters and Donald Trump are, because it's all she's got. It's all she's really got right now. I have not heard her talking about any policy. I have not heard her actually bashing any of Trump's policy that he's come out with. It's all about just bashing him personally, bashing the voters personally, telling people to get out and vote early. That was a good one. I loved that one. When the FBI story broke with her, the new investigation renewed investigation on her emails, I love that she's like, get out there and vote early. If that doesn't speak volumes. Oh, really, Hillary? Why is that? Maybe I want to use this last week or 4 days, whatever's left. Maybe I want to use that to really delve in and do some research. And really choose that candidate that I think will be good for the country. And no, just get to the polls quick. That smells of fear a little bit. Smells of something might be coming out of the molding. Pull the sheetrock off, and you'll see some black mold behind it. That's Hillary. That's Hillary's. I bet she takes that makeup off on a nightly basis, and you just see like water damage and black mold all over her face. Very dangerous. Very toxic. But that's all she has right now. And again, like I was talking about at the top of this break, the polls don't tell me anything. I've said time and time again, this election could be a landslide either way. I don't know. I just don't know. I know what I feel and what I want. Or it could be a squeaker either way. That's how mixed up they've made us as a populace. That's how confused they've done. They've just shoved these graphs in front of us. We don't know what the hell they mean. Anthony Cumia for Infowars.com. Back in a moment. Hello. Anthony Cumia for Infowars.com. So with the election 4 days away, what do we really want? We want security, I think, right? Don't we want to feel safe in our own homes and in our nation from harm? Yeah, I think so. What I've heard from Trump, it sounds like he's more the guy for the job than Hillary Clinton. That's how I see it. Hillary's trying to present Donald Trump as a madman. If you've seen some of her commercials, my God, it harkens back to the days when Reagan was running and they were saying that he's definitely going to get us into a war. They're showing nuclear missile silos and interviewing people that have run the nuclear missile silos and saying, hey, as Donald Trump got, first of all, he's not a politician. This is where they don't know what to do with Donald Trump. He's not a politician. He's been a successful businessman, a builder, an entertainer. And for some reason, that means you're going to launch nuclear missiles. I don't know how they make this make any sense whatsoever. But Hillary's the one that went over and made a uranium deal with the Russians to give them uranium rights. Hillary's the one involved in the Iran nuclear deal that absolutely gives Iran the ability to make nuclear weapons. And you might say, well, that's not till a few years down the road. What are we all leaving at some point? Yeah, it's giving them the ability, the resources they need to build nuclear bombs. That's what that deal did, instead of keeping them under the sanctions that were in place and the restrictions and the ability to bomb them if they got a little crazy with their nuclear program. If you recall, many years ago, Israel decided, hey, look at that. They're building nuclear power plants, which they're going to be able to take nuclear material from and make bombs. What should we do? Bomb them. And now with all the sanctions lifted and no one really keeping an eye on Iran, they've acquired missile defense systems that will be very difficult to get through if the need ever came about to take any kind of military action against their nuclear sites. So again, she screwed us in that respect. Economy. The economy has been in the proverbial crapper, as they say, for 8 years at least. I know it was not at its best at the end of W's term, but man, Obama's done nothing to help that out. And Hillary has done, said nothing more than she will continue with his program and legacy. Insane. Just insane. Trump is a businessman. He's been a successful business. There's no denying that. You could say that, oh, he owed people money. He did this. He's been a successful businessman for many years. So as far as the economy goes and some of the stuff he's been saying about trade, I buy that. And national pride. Again, just being, feeling good about being American again. Just feeling good about it would be, oh, it's been so long, hasn't it? Hasn't it just been so long to show American pride and feel good about the country and the direction it's going in? That would be kind of nice. Am I doing this now? All right. Introducing BioPCA, the ultimate new hair, skin, and nails formula by InfoWars Life. For years, listeners have been asking us to create a game-changing formula that works to give you hair, skin, and nails, the compounds that they really need. No matter how hard we try every single day, we expose ourselves to toxic chemicals. They're wreaking havoc on our skin and hair, from toxic chemicals in the tap water, released in the shower, synthetic garbage in most leading shampoos and body wash. Now